Hey, it's Free Talk Live. Talk to you about whatever is on your mind. You just have to dial in toll free here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. There's obviously more to say about Baltimore, but I do want to get to the story about the Supreme Court that I've been teasing for the last couple of days. So let's jump right into that. Ian and Mark in the studio with you here tonight. The Daily Dot has the story at dailydot.com. In a 6-2 decision, the U.S. Supreme Court ruled on Tuesday, and that was Tuesday of last week, that police officers who prolong traffic stops without just cause are in violation of the Fourth Amendment. Justices concluded in the case of Rodriguez versus United States that police had violated the civil rights of Denny Rodriguez by making him wait while a drug-sniffing dog circled his vehicle without probable cause. Rodriguez, who was pulled over for driving erratically, was ultimately arrested after the dog led officers to a large bag of methamphetamine in the car. Tuesday's decision means that police may not hold you during a traffic stop beyond the amount of time that it takes to write you a ticket, as long as the officer has, quote, no additional reasonable suspicion of a crime, says Ezekiel Edwards, the director of the Criminal Law Reform Project at the ACLU.
You know, it's hard to be excited about a guy who wins at the Supreme Court for having the methamphetamines in his car. Like, he did the act, right, as it were. Now, I don't think that I think the drug war is worse than illegal drugs, but I'm not a big fan of methamphetamines either. Mm-hmm. But I would like to point out, and I think this is really important, is that if you get stopped for, if you get hassled by a cop and have to wait on the side of the road 2 hours for them to bring a dog so that the cop can circle your car and find out there's nothing in there, or the dog alerts and then they search and nothing's in there, or whatever it is that they do, you're just going to go, right? Like, you might call a lawyer, but the lawyer's going to say, sure, we'll be happy to take your case, and it'll be $10,000. And then you'll be like, oh, well, I don't have $10,000, and whatever. And so you're not going to do anything about it unless you're guilty, right? Like, it's mm-hmm. only guilty people that have the motivation, because Mr. Rodriguez is likely spending little time in jail over this, right? And yep. So he's highly motivated to take this case to the Supreme Court. Now, I don't know how much time he got. He could be out at this point, as long as it takes things to get to the Supreme Court, but maybe not. So he's got the motivation to take this stuff on. If I was stopped by a police officer and, you know, searched on the side of the road, and if I had to wait 2 hours and the dog and the whole thing, you know, I'd complain about it on the radio.
Yeah.
I might even talk to some of my lawyer friends, but it's unlikely I'd go any further, because ultimately the 2 hours is lost. How much more time do I want to spend
in
on
court.
This? In court,
yeah.
And all this other stuff, essentially being robbed of my time by the government further. Mr. Rodriguez has been robbed for this foreseeable future of all of his time by the government. So this is within his incentive scope to litigate. And I can understand that. I don't particularly like it. It's difficult to feel a great deal of sympathy for Mr. Rodriguez in this circumstance. Oh, look, a bunch of cops thought that this guy had some drugs in his car. Sure enough, there's a bag of methamphetamines. And, you know, I'm supposed to side with the guy with the bag of methamphetamines.
I'll side with him.
Yeah, so somehow.
It's his methamphetamine, and he should be able to do with it as he damn well pleases.
I hear you.
This actually happened to a friend of mine, Mark, back, it must have been over a decade ago at this point, where he was stopped and he was made to wait for an extended period of time. I don't recall how long it was, but 2 hours sounds about right. I know he was there for a while, and the cops did bring a dog out, and the dog did claw all over the place on his car, ruining his paint job. They went inside the car. The cops then searched it. They tore up the carpets from his car. I mean, they just messed it up. And so he was pretty upset. Like, he had some damage in addition to being inconvenienced for a couple of hours. And this was at, I think, like 2 a.m. or some late night hour, midnight, something like that. And so he was upset enough to actually contact some attorneys to see, you know, hey, I feel like my rights have been violated here. can we do something about this?
Uh-huh.
And he couldn't find any attorneys who were willing to take a case against the Sarasota Police Department.
So he had nothing in the vehicle.
That's correct.
So he, yeah, I mean, and this is ultimately how it goes, right? Like, you know, they, it's just not worth the trouble. He called a couple of attorneys, right? Maybe
two or three or something. Yeah,
two or three attorneys, and they were all in Sarasota County, and they're all like, you know what? I got to work with these guys. I got to work with the prosecutor. Whatever you're going to get out of this just isn't worth it for me. Why don't you call somebody from Jacksonville? And or whatever. And of course, they charge extra and to come on down the 5 hours or whatever it is. And, you know, that's what it comes down to. It's essentially how much do you want to be robbed for this injustice? Because it's unlikely that, I mean, the Supreme Court, I don't know that they ever give damages to somebody. You know, you're not likely to say.
I don't know if they can.
Yeah, I don't know if they can either. I mean,
they can just overturn a verdict. Right,
right. So. You know, I mean, what am I gonna get out of it?
You would have to sue again.
Because for me to take this to court and get something, I'd have to get $100,000 or more for me to even think like, yeah, I won something. As a matter of fact, the lawyer's gonna get a third of that, so that's 66.
At least.
God
mm-hmm.
knows how much time I put into this. I mean, I would rather work, you know, work at my job than do this lawyering stuff. I find dealing with the legal system to be so disgusting and reprehensible. You'd have to pay me at like five times what I consider my hourly rate to be, whatever that might be.
To make you want to do it, to make you want to go through with it. So back to the story here at the Daily Dot. If the officer unnecessarily prolongs the stop, it constitutes an unreasonable seizure and a violation of your constitutional rights. The use of the drug-sniffing dog in Rodriguez is but one illustration of how such a violation might occur. So what, if any, substantive effect does the High Court's decision have during an actual police encounter? With the expert help of ACLU's Ezekiel Edwards, we've put together a comprehensive guide, none of which is meant as actual legal advice.
I love how they have to do this. We're going to put a guide together, sort of giving you legal advice, but because the country is so messed up and our litigation system so messed up, we have to say that this legal advice isn't legal advice.
Right. It comes from the ACLU's expert, and it's still not legal advice.
I mean, we have to say those. We say those things on the air all the time because, you know, I mean, you're just saying whatever you're saying. You're trying to give your best opinion. Is it advice? Well, not if we can get sued for it. It's not.
So this is what you're. This is what to do if you're pulled over and the police want to bring out the dogs. Which
but it's
is,
not legal advice,
right? Which is not uncommon, by the way. There are a lot of people who have had this situation where they've just been pulled over and the cops just say, you know, hey, you got to stay here while we bring out a police dog to sniff your car because you won't let us search. They'll ask to search if you are standing on your rights and, you know, you want to protect yourself, even if you don't have anything in your car. The right thing to do, in my opinion, is to not consent to a search. You don't want to let them get away with that.
It sounds like it is now. Like that's.
I think it's always been the right thing to do.
Well,
you don't want to let them.
I'm not
get
interested
in
what's right, Ian. I'm interested in what's right for me. Right. I understand that you have a higher moral cause that you're you know that's fine for you, but I'm not willing to spend hours and hours of time in jail for other people's rights that they're not willing to spend
These
time
are
in
your
jail
rights.
For.
They're your rights.
Right.
You either stand up for them and retain them, or bow down, bend over, and then you lose them.
Yeah. Well,
your choice.
I get where you're coming from, but do you understand that standing up to police sometimes has negative results?
So does not standing up to the police.
Sometimes it does.
You want to get drugs planted in your car? There's a good chance they'll plant them if they're searching your car.
Right, and I think that that's a really important thing to point out, is look, when the police are searching your car, oftentimes what they'll do is they'll either distract you or they'll actually tell you to turn around and look the other direction while they're mm-hmm. searching. And that means they can do whatever they want. And at that point, you're trusting the upstanding honor of this police officer to not plant something in your car.
How much damage? If you don't want to spend time on the side of the road, again, prior to this court decision, how much damage to your car is worth the hour or so? Because they might tear up your carpets, cut up your seats, throw everything out of the back. Let's say you're traveling, you got a bunch of stuff in the back, just going to chuck it all out in the back. You get to put it back in. That sounds like fun, doesn't it? 855-450-FREE. Oh, yeah, and you lose your rights. 855-450-FREE. More from the ACLU here on Police Pullovers in moments.
Honestly, we canceled an appointment to have Jake euthanized to give Dynavite a chance to save this dog's life. Jake is an 8-year-old male Akita. His entire stomach and groin area, his face, his elbows, his ears. Every orifice was just riddled with yeast and sores. We had a vet treat him, and Jake didn't respond at all. My son heard the commercial for Dynavite.
DINOVITE.com.
859-428-1000.
The omega-3 fatty acids.
Flaxseed, zinc, alfalfa.
The digestive enzymes that are cooked out of regular dog food.
Within 4 days, Jake started to heal. It was the most amazing thing I have ever seen. The yeast is receding, and now his belly is completely cleared up. It chokes me up. It brings tears to my eyes. Everything we tried failed except the Dynavite.
859-428-1000.
859-428-1000.
DINOVITE.com.
Making the right decisions is a challenge to investors. Are we going to see economic growth, slide into a recession, or at worst, depression? Hi, Ted Anderson from Midas Resources. We all know when a company acts irresponsibly, divesting ourselves in a move towards safety is prudent. When the market becomes volatile, U.S. treasuries are a safe haven. But what do you do when the U.S. government overextends itself and spends beyond its means? Many investors are turning toward gold as a common sense alternative to traditional paper investments. Midas Resources has put together a powerful book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, discussing costs, benefits, risks, featuring full-color illustrations, weights, and measures. The book is free and can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. Paper investments are dwarfed by gold's 6,000-year history. Discover how gold may be right for you and your IRA by calling 800-686-2237. Whether buying or it's time for you to sell, the book is free. Call 800-686-2237.
That just about everybody.
Free Talk Live.
For me, it's fighting negativity, and the negativity is my thoughts in my head that are negative. And I had to learn to recognize when my thoughts were being negative, because most of my life, most of my thoughts were negative.
Mm-hmm.
So I had to become aware of when they were happening. And when I become aware of these negative thoughts pervading my thinking. I immediately fight them with positive thoughts. And most of the positive thoughts that I feed myself are positive affirmations about who I am, where I'm going, where I've come from.
Whenever I find myself thinking negatively, I don't consider it fighting the negative thoughts. I just consider it changing my train of thought. I just kind of change tracks to a positive thought and just focus on that.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com. LRN.FM needs your help getting our satellite signal back on in Africa. Our satellite provider had us on at no charge from 2012 through February of this year when they pulled the channel off the air. Now we're trying to raise $22,000 to continue reaching people with the message of liberty in places where it's needed most. Please visit our Indiegogo fundraiser at africa.lrn.fm. Give what you can and share the link with your friends. africa.lrn.fm.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll-free and share with us whatever's on your mind here. 855-450-FREE. Coming up, the suggestions. Not legal advice, the suggestions from the ACLU in the wake of this Supreme Court decision that has actually, it's a pretty good decision. It's pretty rare that they have good decisions, but you know, we like to point them out when that does happen. And this is about your rights on the side of the road when the police are threatening you with a drug dog to come out and sniff around your car, possibly being alerted by the police officer to make it look like they found something in your car to give them the excuse to search. We'll tell you a little bit more about what the court decided here and the interpretation of what that could mean for you here in a moment. Also, I want to let you know about ProXPN. If you get online at all, whether it's on a smartphone or a laptop or your desktop computer, you can use ProXPN to protect you from prying and spying by people like, oh, let's say your internet service provider, who's probably logging all the websites you visit. They may be keeping those logs for several years in some cases. You can stop that from happening with ProXPN. Plus, criminals trying to sniff out your Wi-Fi packets, ProXPN protects you there as well. And they do it because they encrypt your data connection. So once you get the ProXPN app for free at proxpn.com/FTL, you get it for Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, Linux. You download the app, get it installed and running. It takes just a moment. And then once you're connected to ProXPN, you are encrypted, which is a big level of protection you can add to yourself. Again, you can get started for free at proxpn.com/FTL. When you're ready to upgrade to their premium account for unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can access, you can privately torrent and get past regionally blocked websites with ProXPN and their premium account by using code FTL50. That gets you 50% off that annual account price, and that brings the price down to about $5 a month when you average it out. ProXPN.com/FTL, code FTL50. It's a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee, and it's a great discount on privacy that's priceless. ProXPN.com/FTL and code FTL50. Let's go to Caitlin. She is in St. George, Utah, listening to KZNU. Hey, Caitlin.
Hi.
Hey there. You're on the radio.
I am just the opposing side of this whole police bashing session. Have you ever thought that there are good cops out there?
What's that have to do with police officers being able to hold you on the side of the road for 2 hours while a dog comes up and searches your car?
Well, I understand maybe not the 2 hours, but I mean, if there's reasonable cause.
But that you're leaving that to somebody who's who's over whom we don't have control. What is reasonable to you is not reasonable to me necessarily, right?
Yes and no. I mean, they're there to do their job.
Yes, but
they
what is their job?
They don't want to be there maybe as much as, I mean, you don't want to be there.
Well, if they didn't want to be there, they could just let you go after giving you the speeding ticket rather than, you know, demanding that you stick around and wait around until they can then violate your rights.
But what, I mean, if they think there's a thing, there's a thing. My
if
dad's
they think
a
there's
cop.
A thing,
he's a drug
there's
a dog thief. Cop.
Oh, a thief.
She's claiming that cops have super sensory perception. And this is absolutely ridiculous. Yes, over time you will get better at your job. There's no doubt about it. But you're going to be wrong. I am a pretty good talk show host. I've been doing this for 12 years, but I mess
obviously
up.
Obviously, you're going to be wrong.
Yeah. And when you're wrong and you're a cop.
Every job.
But when you're wrong and you're a cop, you violate people's human rights.
When you're wrong, also when you're a cop, then people get hurt. So I would rather be sitting on the side of the road for 2 hours than end up dead 2 hours later because somebody didn't do their job.
Just so you know, these searches are primarily being used to find people with drugs. So
I don't know what else they'd find.
Your life isn't in jeopardy, maybe like a weapons cache or something like that.
I've never heard of a weapons dog.
That, but I mean, if you're talking about this, you're talking about another thing and another thing.
No, not really. When you're talking about dogs searching cars, you're really talking about dogs searching cars for drugs.
Yeah.
And you probably have never been assaulted with a bag of meth.
Okay.
Right? I mean, has anybody ever tried to hit you with a bag of meth?
Okay. But I've listened to this show many, many times, and
yes.
It's frequently talking about how cops are always, I'm just saying, there is bad cops, obviously.
Yep.
But there are good cops that are doing their job.
Okay, that's a different conversation. That's a different conversation, and I think that that's true. There are good cops. The question I would have for you is because I have done this, like I said, for 12 years I've been doing this, and I was the stalwart defender of police on the show for years. But the problem, Caitlin, is what I found is that over time I would watch these videos of police officers abusing people, and there would be the good cops would be standing around. It wouldn't be one police officer beating somebody up. It would be either one police officer beating somebody up and then nine cops standing around, or a police officer beating somebody up and then all of them would jump in and pile in. I couldn't find the good cops on video nearly as often as I could find the bad ones. So
well, can
what
you
percentage
ever find the good things on video versus the bad things? I mean, who's going to video?
Sure. You can find them.
Okay,
I mean, there was a police officer that gave...
I just want some damn respect for the good cops that are out there putting their life on the line, like my dad, who's almost gone killed multiple
like
times.
Like daddy.
Well, yeah, okay, so putting your life on the line, that's another thing that really needs to be pointed out. Nobody ever thanks the fishermen or the truck drivers, which are far more dangerous professions than police officers. I mean, is that what
we're... I thank them.
Really? Nobody ever does. Nobody calls in here and says, you know, there's good fishermen out there.
Well, I'm sorry.
Yep.
Caitlin, here's what I want to say, you know, in response to what you've brought up here, the idea about that there's all these good cops out there. Do you think good cops try to search people's vehicles for drugs?
Yes.
Well, I don't agree with you. I think that's a bad person. Somebody who violates another person's privacy and the sanctity of another person's space is not a good person.
Okay. So I pull over somebody, I smell some drugs, I'm not going to search their car.
Yeah, because if you're a good person, if that person is simply, you know, not putting anyone in danger, they're just driving down the road, then, yeah, there's no reason for you to go and paw through all of their possessions to see if they have something that you can put them in a prison for 5 years for. Who cares if it's illegal?
It's
it used to be illegal to shuttle escaped slaves along the Underground Railroad. Would you have supported the police going after those people who are holding on to escaped slaves in their homes?
No, but that's a whole different ballgame.
No, ma'am, it is not a whole different ballgame. We're still talking about innocent people.
I fundamentally believe that drugs are bad. I don't believe that slavery
drink?
Is bad. No.
You've never had a drink.
Never in my life.
Wow, well, good for you. So you would you support bringing back alcohol prohibition?
No.
Why?
Well, I
Alcohol's
think that
bad.
People can do it semi-responsibly.
Wait a minute. Hold on. Didn't you just say drugs are bad? Is
yes.
it only the illegal drugs that are bad in your mind, or is it all drugs that are bad?
Well, it depends.
Uh-huh. So there's no consistency in your opinions.
Yeah,
right.
So Caitlin, what the point he's trying to make here is that, look, laws are words written on pieces of paper by politicians, people that we generally consider to be liars and thieves and pretty bad folks. So to just say that because something's illegal, that it is wrong, is ridiculous. In the same way that, you know, the Nazis hunting down Jews was legal and bringing slaves back to their masters was completely legal. It was the law. It was illegal to do otherwise. When the Quakers hid black people in their basement, illegal. And so therefore, what he's trying to point out to you is that this behavior that has become illegal isn't necessarily wrong.
And you could go ask your dad if he was a police officer if he ever met any responsible drug users, because I can tell you, you probably know a bunch of them, but they probably won't ever tell you about their drug habits or usage because, well, you might turn them in.
I know a judge.
Thanks for the call. More coming up here. Free Talk Live.
Gold. It's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2233 for the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
Who told you to go this way?
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring signs into the rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm
comfortable
me.
Here, actually.
Whoa, whoa,
excuse
whoa,
me.
Whoa, whoa.
Hey,
who do you think you
excuse
are?
Excuse me.
There is no video and audio allowed in this office.
No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't gonna make it.
Wait,
now.
Wait a minute.
Whoa. Hey! Oh, my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running from me?
Because you scared me!
Property.
What am I being
now.
Detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're
Democrats have a funny way of telling people no. That's the sound of the men
working on the chain. Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com.
If you're a liberty and freedom-oriented American, come to the 3rd Annual Arizona Freedom Fest at Schatz Ranch Shooting Range, May 1st through May 3rd. Fun for the whole family. Lots of stuff for the kids and lots of great guest speakers and events for everyone. Food, music, shopping, and more. Speakers include Sheriff Richard Mack, Derek Grayson, Joel Skousen, and many more. Plenty of camping room at Schatz Ranch. For tickets or more info, go to arizonafreedomfest.com. That's the 3rd Annual Arizona Freedom Fest at Schatz Ranch, May 1st through May 3rd.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Here's a breaking medical legal alert. Attention, users of the diabetes drug Actos. If you or a loved one has taken Actos, then developed bladder cancer, or if a loved one has died from bladder cancer after taking Actos, you may be entitled to significant financial compensation from the pharmaceutical giants who made these drugs. Our experienced attorneys are dedicated to help you get the money you're entitled to, but time may be running out on this opportunity. So you must call today. The information is free. There are no fees unless we win your case. If you or a loved one has developed bladder cancer or something worse after taking the diabetes drug Actos, call right now and learn your legal rights. This is an advertisement not valid in all states. I am a paid non-attorney spokesperson. Call the Tort Attorneys 24/7 right now. 800-430-7924. 800-430-7924. That's 800-430-7924.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. Dial in toll free. Right here, 855-450-FREE. We'll talk more about your rights when it comes to the roadside searches that the police just love to pull on you when people have been pulled over. If the cops don't like the way they look, they're driving while young, driving while poor, driving while black, driving while Hispanic, driving with long hair as a male. All of those things, that has resulted in many, many people being harassed on the side of the road, having their cars searched, having their possessions seized, and having their persons, their bodies, locked in cages for not having harmed a single human being.
Yeah, and
it's horrifying.
We don't know how many people have been kept on the side of the road for, I don't know, 45 minutes to 2 hours.
I know several friends who have.
How many of them had drugs in their car?
None.
Okay, none.
One guy had some prescription pills. James Cleveland had something, but he actually has a prescription for it, but it wasn't in its prescription bottle, so now he's facing misdemeanor charges.
I see. We don't know, right? Like, this is one of the costs of the drug war that we just don't know. When you drive by, the cops have somebody pulled over, they're going through their car, you have no idea if that person's guilty. The cops are just, in many cases, working on a hunch. Because first they'll say things to you like, I'm going to have to ask you to step out, I'm going to have you to let me search the car now. Yep. And they'll say that in a fashion that sounds so much like an order that you're going to do it, because humans tend to be obeisant to authority figures.
Put their hand on their gun while they say it, too.
Yeah, sometimes they'll do that, right? I've had a police officer come up to my car with his hand on his gun, and I said, "Officer, remove your hand from your service weapon while you speak to me."
Whoa.
Yeah, I've got it on
Where's
video.
Where's the video of this?
Why would I say? Nothing else happened. He did.
Oh, okay. That's good.
Because it's just inappropriate as hell to put your hand on a gun while you talk to somebody.
Well,
I mean,
if I
was fingering a gun while I spoke to the police officer,
it would not
be appropriate
well.
At all. But who do these people think they are?
They think they're your masters.
I said, all of these proceedings are being audio and video recorded, and he said, yes, they are by me, too. I said, very good. Then we're all on the record here.
You know how you can one bit of evidence that they think you are, they are your master is that they call you a subject.
They don't usually say it to your face, though. They won't call you a subject. They'll refer
they talk
to
about you behind your
in
back
your third in the third person as a subject.
So we can continue here. I want to get to your calls and thoughts, but also want to tell you how to get a great deal on some absolutely amazing wine from chwine.com. The CH stands for Cameron Hughes, and he's a guy who's created an interesting business model. He actually goes around to different wineries, these places that create the wine, the fancy wineries, and he goes and he buys their excess. He buys either the excess wine they've already produced, or actually will buy the excess fruit, and then he'll just make it right there in their facility.
Yeah,
apparently.
Sometimes they do that.
So it's just an amazing product because it's what you get from the fancy pants wineries, except you're paying a fraction of the price. So normally these bottles could be upwards of $100, but at chwine.com they're like $15 to $30, and that's before you factor in the discounts that you're about to tell me about.
Right. Well, we recently had this cab, Cabernet Sauvignon, I believe is how it's pronounced. I'm not entirely sure.
Yes, I would like more of that cab.
It was great. Really lot 502. It was really awesome, full-bodied. And
that's how you can reorder, is you get the lot number, and if you like it, you can get more.
It's sold out, except for a small reserve for our listeners. And you can, it's exclusive online, and you can get this incredible wine, this high-end wine that should be $100 a bottle. And, you know, you could just go there and get it for 20% off if you use our code. Now, this is until Friday. So please use our coupon code FTL. You go to chwine.com. Click on the microphone in the upper left-hand corner, then type in FTL. You will then get 20% off of lot 502, this Cabernet Sauvignon, that's at this point sold out except for a small reserve for our audience. Apparently, we are particularly good at selling wine, and it's a good thing because it's really great wine. Please check it out, chwine.com. Click on the microphone in the upper left-hand corner and enter FTL and get this great cab. 20% off and free shipping.
Free shipping. All right, you can't beat that. Let's continue here. Your calls and thoughts, then more on the drug dog situation. First, Ron's in North Carolina listening to Talk Radio 850. Hey, Ron.
Hello there. Yeah, it's an honor speaking with you guys. Anyways, I got a story about a cop pulling me over on my motorcycle. Actually, I've been pulled over on my motorcycle quite a bit over the years, but this occurred on a cross-country trip that I was taking about 5 summers ago.
Ron, if I might interrupt briefly, are you on a hands-free device of some sort? Just curious.
Yes, I'm on a cell phone.
Yeah, okay. If it was a hands-free device, it might be muffling you a little bit. It's not bad, though, so you can continue. Sorry, didn't mean to ruin everything.
Is it better?
Yeah, it actually is a little clearer. Go ahead, sir.
All right. Anyways, I have a concealed carry permit here in my home state of North Carolina, and I thought that it would probably be a good idea to carry that with me when I was doing this cross country trip. I planned on being on the road for about a month. Camping out in state parks, different places where there's grizzly bears and whatever. But there are, unfortunately, some states that aren't reciprocal. So, you can be in pretty serious trouble if you got caught carrying one, like in California, for example.
Right.
But anyway, I was on my way back home. I had actually had a couple of buds with me as well. I picked up from a friend out there. I'm going down through Lake Tahoe. And beautiful place.
It is.
I was wanting to go and check that out, so I was. But anyhow, I hear some hollering behind me, and this is right in downtown. Tourists all over the place and whatnot. There was a bicycle cop trying to pull me over. So, anyways, I figured I might as well castrate myself rather than have a bicycle cop pull me over on my Harley. So I figured if I can just kind of get out of town, I wasn't like I was running away from him because he'd fall behind, and then I'd get caught in traffic, and, he'd catch up a little bit. All the while, he's hollering and yelling and waving his arms, but he never got right beside me. Anyhow, another cop comes out of a side street driving a Tahoe, so I had no choice but to stop. He wanted to pull me over, or he wanted to, search me, ask me where I was going and where I was coming from. I was all polite and all, everything with him, and he asked me if he could search my motorcycle, and Well, you know, I had the pistol in the bottom of one saddlebag. I had the clips in the bottom of another saddlebag, and the other stuff was hidden pretty well. So I, you know, kind of, oh, this could be bad, you know? So I told him, I said, well, yeah, sure, man, go right ahead, search my thing. I don't have anything to hide. Well, let me tell you. Let me finish. I opened up the saddlebag, and I said, but I need to tell you, please, you know, for your own good, and, you know, to avoid any embarrassment, I said, you need to get yourself some rubber gloves because, you know, I'm all feral looking. I've been on the road for, you know, at this point, probably at least a couple of weeks. I said, I've got some nasty underwear in there, skid marks all over it. And, you know, just for your own good, just, you know, biohazard kind of thing, just get yourself some gloves. So the cop that was in the Tahoe, he's just kind of standing there chuckling a little bit. And the other guy says, get out of here.
Nice move.
Well, I'm glad it worked out.
I've never heard that one before. That's a pretty good story. So that was it, huh?
Well, but yeah, that was it. I got out of there, you know, and the reason why he pulled me over was he said that I failed to yield right away to a pedestrian in a crosswalk. Well, apparently if a person steps off of the sidewalk onto the road, you got to come to a panic stop immediately. I didn't even see that person. It was not anything near like a close call or nothing, you know. But if I had refused to let him search and he had gotten a dog and all that kind of stuff, it could have turned out a whole lot worse, you know. But anyways, that's just my story.
It certainly could have.
Yeah, I really hate that whole thing where, you know, that a pedestrian comes near a crosswalk and suddenly everybody's got to slam on their brakes.
That's how it is here in New Hampshire.
As a pedestrian, look, I can get past the cars. Yes, once I'm out there in the middle, please come to a stop. But, you know, everybody on the whole darn road doesn't have to stop. We can work our way around. Also, you know, pushing the button to get across the street. Grown adults don't know how to read traffic lights.
Hey, Ron, good story. Thanks for sharing it tonight. And he's certainly right that there's no guarantee, right? Like, if you refuse a search, it may be that it could be more hassle if they want to mess with you. But on the other hand, I think a good general rule of thumb is to refuse searches just because that's the right thing to do. Oh, and of course, record the stop as well. More coming up.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
Sorry, I'm late.
When the leading antihistamine and Nasacort go nose-to-nose, Nasacort wins, stopping more of the chemical responses that can cause your nasal allergy symptoms. And when you stop more causes, you get 24-hour relief from sneezing, an itchy runny nose, even congestion. It's prescription-strength medicine available over-the-counter. Nasacort Allergy 24-hour. Stops more of what makes you miserable. Use as directed.
If the IRS has garnished your paycheck or seized money from your bank account, you need to get professional tax help now. Fast action is required to put a halt to these aggressive IRS collection tactics. You can count on the knowledgeable team of tax professionals at Wall & Associates. With over 30 years of experience, Wall & Associates has settled the tax problems of thousands of taxpayers for a small fraction of what they owed. For a free face-to-face consultation, call 1-800-425-4610 to put a wall between you and the IRS. 1-800-425-4610 or look for us on the web at wallandassociates.net. We solve tax problems. If you hire Wall & Associates today, you'll never have to talk to the IRS again. To stop the levies and seizures today, take action now. Call Wall & Associates at 1-800-425-4610. Wall & Associates, 1-800-425-4610. Based on actual cases, results may vary, not a solicitation for legal services.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website, fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper, FPP News, at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at lrn.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at lrn.fm. That's lrn.fm.
My name is Jacob Hornberger. I'm president of the Future of Freedom Foundation, which Congressman Ron Paul awarded for having an outstanding freedom website. Write us at fff@fff.org, and we'll send you a free 3-month subscription to our monthly journal of libertarian essays and our booklet, Economic Liberty in the Constitution, which George Mason University economics professor Walter Williams praised in a recent column. That's fff@fff.org.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. Dial on in toll free. Join us here on the radio waves, 855-450-FREE, or the satellite or internet waves. Either one's fine. We'll be here for you. We're here 7 nights a week, as a matter of fact, live. You can join us online over at freetalklive.com. Please enjoy the features that we share with you on the site over at freetalklive.com. You get to create the content. Whatever you see there on the front page was submitted by listeners like you. So once again, go to freetalklive.com and enjoy.
The Sherry's Berries. It's time for Sherry's Berries season again.
Is it really? It must be Mother's Day.
Yep, Mother's Day is rolling around, and this is a great Mother's Day gift.
When is it this year? We got a couple weeks out or something?
Well, it's
like that?
The second Sunday in May.
Okay.
Every time.
Got it.
And so, you know, I don't have the date here sitting here in front of me, but I know that it's about 2 weeks away if Sherry's Berries is advertising on the show. So, yeah, you can get a great savings on these berries. First, I want to tell you about them. They are delicious, juicy, premium strawberries. And when I say premium, when you get berries from the store, about half of them are sour.
It's hard to pick them at the store.
It is.
You just can't get a good box.
Sherry's Berries picks through them and then sends the extras to homeless shelters.
Wow.
They know, somehow they have a system for picking out berries. I don't know what it is.
Well, they definitely know their berries.
But they're always the best berries. And then they dip them in white milk and dark chocolate and, you know, decorative
swizzles
and swizzles
nuts
and
chips
stuff on them. They're beautiful, but you know, I mean, beautiful is one thing. I know that's important to a lot of people. Presentation, they are delicious. They're some of the best things you're ever going to put in your mouth, and mom is going to love them. So go to berries.com and click on the microphone in the upper corner there and enter FTL. It's a great way to save 40%. So these berries start at $19.99. Now, for $10 more, you can upgrade. I highly recommend doing that.
You'll double the berries for $10 more.
You double the berries for $10 more. So go to berries.com. That's berries.com. Click on the microphone in the upper right corner. Click in FTL. Berries.com, microphone upper right, FTL. And get the savings, because mom's going to love these. And they're a wonderful gift, and you support Free Talk Live in the process.
Yep.
We do a good job of selling berries for them.
You can't go wrong with that one. Berries.com, code FTL. Don't forget the code so we get credit for it. 855-450-FREE, because this thing's being advertised all over talk radio.
Yeah.
I mean, this is huge. Sherry's Berries is huge, and for good reason. I mean, they've grown to the size they are because they provide a quality product.
That's right. If you don't use coupon code FTL, the statists win.
It's true. So berries.com, code FTL. All right, back to the story here. We started at the beginning of the hour from the Daily Dot about the Supreme Court decision 6-2 that determined that the police cannot hold you during a traffic stop beyond the amount of time that it takes to write you the ticket, so long as there's no additional reasonable suspicion that you've committed some other crime. So here's the suggestions from the ACLU. It's not legal advice as to what you should know if you get pulled over and demanded to search. So you've been pulled over. If you've been pulled over by a police officer for a traffic violation, he may ask to see your license and registration and proof of insurance.
Or she.
Provide him with the documents, but keep your hands in sight if you're not at an international border where your rights are different or being questioned by an immigration agent.
If you're at a border, just roll over because it's over.
You don't have to disclose what country you were born in or whether you're a United States citizen. Absent probable cause, the officer cannot legally detain you for any longer than it takes to address the purpose of the traffic stop. He might question you about why you were pulled or why you were pulled you over, I think why he pulled you over,
yeah.
Or inquire about your destination. You have the right to remain silent. If you wish to invoke it, let the officer know. Unfortunately, you do have to do that.
Right.
Now.
This same Supreme Court who were cheering on after this ruling said that in order to invoke your right to remain silent, you must speak.
It's ridiculous.
Otherwise, it might be considered suspicious.
If you don't know why you're being detained, you have the right to ask. Once the officer has issued a citation or warning, ask him if you're free to leave. In point of fact, you can ask that question at any point.
Keep asking it over and over.
Yeah. So if the police have probable cause to search your car, then they don't need your permission.
Right. They wouldn't be asking you. And ask in this circumstance can sound like an order. So you need to be very careful. When you're dealing with legal land, they tend to say things a bit different.
I'm going to have to ask to search your car.
Right. They might say something just like that. I'm going to have to ask you to let me search your car now. I'm going to have to ask you to step out of the vehicle.
Absent suspicion, police can only search your car if you consent to a search, which is why they're asking, just to be clear. And if you're not clear on what the officer's saying to you, then you can ask questions to clarify. Excuse me, are you asking or are you ordering me to step out of the car?
I'm just not sure.
Well, no, they'll have to give you a clear answer, or generally they should give you a clear answer.
I meant that you can say, I'm just not sure. I'm just not sure what you're saying to me, officer.
Yeah.
Just trying to be clear.
Yeah, so you can ask for clarification. Most attorneys would advise you politely refuse the request, regardless of how the question is phrased. If an officer asks if he can let a drug dog sniff around your car after you've been given a ticket, he's asking your permission to continue detaining you. If you intentionally and voluntarily say yes, and the dog signals to the officer there may be an illicit substance inside, he will then have probable cause to search your vehicle.
And studies have shown that police officers, if they believe that there is something there, that they can get the dog to alert. So that's the dogs. I mean, dogs want to serve their masters, right? I mean, doesn't your dog love you and want to do what you want him to do?
Pretty much.
Yeah. So, the dogs will alert if the just because they empathetically understand that the police officer believes there's something there, and so therefore they're a good boy if they
ball in it for them or something like that later on.
If you do it, you know, as a dog, if you do what your master wants you to do, and you're a good reader of what your master wants, you're gonna alert.
So if you if you agree to the dog sniff, and if you're just sitting there and you continue to if you don't ask the question, am I free to go, and you just can kind of keep going along with whatever pattern of questions they're asking you, then that is essentially you sort of tacitly consenting to it. You have to assert your rights if you want to have rights. You have rights, but you have to assert them. And the police will not assert them for you.
No,
they will generally
it's not their job.
Right. They will generally not give you an opportunity or an opening to assert your rights.
They don't like the legal world any more than anyone else, as evidenced by the caller that called in earlier, whose father's a police officer. You know, they're not police officers who are there to uphold the law are generally not saying, yes, the Supreme Court says that, drivers may now, I can't hold drivers on the side of the road, indefinitely until a dog comes. I love it when the law is clarified for me. They're not law enforcement officers so much as they have a goal, and the goal is to catch the bad guys. In the case of the Rodriguez case, the guy had a bag of methamphetamines in his car. Well, you know, it's hard to feel a lot of sympathy for this dude.
I can empathize with him.
You can. I can understand where you're coming from, but I can also see how the cops are like, we found somebody with meth. We were right.
Yeah, but it's still wrong to do that because it's a violation of that person's privacy.
Yeah, but that's not what the Supreme Court's saying. The Supreme Court's saying is not saying that you, the American public, have a right to tote around bags of methamphetamine with you.
No, they haven't overturned the war on drugs.
And they're not going to anytime soon.
No. If you wish to refuse a search or you don't want to consent to have your car sniffed by a drug dog, say so loudly and clearly and then ask for permission to leave, Edwards recommends. This is the ACLU attorney. If he says no and your traffic violation has already been fully addressed, then it's likely you're being unlawfully detained. Remember, the Rodriguez ruling did not outlaw the use of drug sniffing dogs. It only prolonging the traffic stop to use them. That's what is now illegal for the police to do. One police officer could still walk a dog around your car while another issues you a ticket. As long as it doesn't extend the duration of the stop,
it's true.
They're in the clear. So if you get pulled by a canine unit, you know, they got you.
And there's two officers.
Yeah.
But what that officer cannot do is take your driver's license, go back, put it in his car, get his dog, come out, search the car, then go back.
I don't know about that, Mark.
That's prolonging it.
He could claim that they're processing the ticket or something.
They're
like that.
Very clear, as I understand. Well, he could claim that, and then we'll find out. But they've been very clear that it's the length of time it takes to write a ticket. Mm-hmm. Now, they can write slow, but they can't stop and pick up you'll get the dog and bring him out. That would be my interpretation.
That's your interpretation.
This.
Fair enough.
And just like the ACLU, this is not legal advice.
Right. So, and by the way, they're not suggesting this in here yet anywhere that I've seen, but please record these interactions. I think one of the best things you can do to hold police accountable and to stand on your rights is to have an objective record of what happened in that day. You can't trust the police to record it. You've got to be the one to take responsibility for that.
As the behavior gets normalized, that is recording police officers, there will be less and less trouble for doing it too.
That's
true. I wouldn't say be a jackhole about it. Just record as best you can.
855-450-FREE. More suggestions coming up here from the ACLU about police searches.
Kid, this facility is like a ship. So how do I keep us on course without micromanaging every detail? Easy, with Grainger. Grainger's online tools help give me the visibility I need. I can shop, order, and manage all our activity. Oversee purchases, control costs, all while you guys get to order what you need when you need it. I run a tight ship, kid. I run it with Grainger. Get it? Got it? Good. Learn more at Grainger.com/online purchasing. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938, 877-357-9938.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more.
It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, April 28th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.58 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,206 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $226. Antiwar.com reports during the brief summer Israeli war against the Gaza Strip, Israeli forces repeatedly attacked UN facilities, particularly schools that they knew for a fact were full of displaced civilians. The UN inquiry expressed dismay at the Israeli strikes, noting they killed 44 Palestinian civilians and wounded 227 others in attacks on emergency shelters. Israel has defended the attacks, insisting that other closed schools were being used to hide weapons. Oddly, those sites don't appear to have been attacked, and Israel instead hit UN sites that they knew were loaded down with civilians that had just days prior been ordered out of their homes by the Israeli military. Pentagon lawyers issued their own report, and while they insisted they weren't judging specific incidents, they did praise the Israeli military, insisting that the decisions on targets to strike were largely in line with what the U.S. military would have done under the same circumstances. The killings loom large in a potential ICC investigation into Israeli war crimes against civilians in the occupied territories and reflect the continued efforts by the U.S. to keep Israel immune from any consequences for their actions. In Survivor Max by Davi Barker, 11-year-old Max must survive the zombie apocalypse alone in New Hampshire. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the lame brains swarm his home searching for living flesh. Max must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to plan his escape, but first, he must prove that he's too smart to die. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook and Amazon, or read Chapter 1 free at SurvivorMax.com. UPI reports Maryland Governor Larry Hogan declared a state of emergency Monday and deployed the National Guard in response to violent clashes between police and rioters. Demonstrators in Baltimore turned violent after the funeral of Freddie Gray, who died after suffering a broken spine while in police custody. Protesters appeared to hurl items at police, and authorities used pepper spray to try to disperse the crowd. Hogan said the looting and acts of violence in Baltimore will not be tolerated. He added in a statement, "I strongly condemn the actions of the offenders who are engaged in direct attacks against innocent civilians, businesses, and law enforcement officers. There is a significant difference between protesting and violence, and those committing these acts will be prosecuted under the fullest extent of the law." At a news conference held by Baltimore officials Monday evening, Police Colonel Daryl D'Souza said 15 officers were injured, two of them remain hospitalized. CNN reports one of its photographers was also injured and transported to a hospital. There is no report on the number of protesters injured by police. For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. Reuters reports a day before the U.S. Supreme Court hears landmark arguments on whether the Constitution provides a right to same-sex marriage, activists on both sides of the contentious social issue converged on the white marble courthouse to voice their views. Anti-gay rights activists rallied in front of the courthouse steps condemning same-sex marriage, while a line snaked around the block of people, many displaying gay rights messages, hoping to snag one of the limited number of seats available in the courtroom for Tuesday's 2.5-hour oral arguments. The nine justices will be hearing arguments concerning same-sex marriage restrictions imposed in Kentucky, Michigan, Ohio, and Tennessee, four of the 13 states that still outlaw such marriages. The ruling, due by the end of June, will determine whether same-sex marriage will be legal nationwide. At a small Monday morning rally, opponents of same-sex marriage railed against judges who have struck down state same-sex marriage bans. Tuesday's arguments will be divided into two parts. The first, set for 90 minutes, is on whether the Constitution's guarantee of due process and equal protection under the law means states must allow same-sex couples to marry. The second part, scheduled for an hour, concerns whether states must recognize same-sex marriages that take place out of state. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
The push to legalize marijuana is gaining momentum. These prescription doobies will do a whole lot more than just give patients a case of the munchies.
Proponents are piping up to say that medical marijuana can help patients with some of the chronic illnesses that have been majorly killing their buzz. Unfortunately, 36 U.S. states are still not a kind bud of the legalization argument. But in states that do have the plan, the results have been, well, pretty far out, man. Patients nationwide are bluntly asking state legislatures to finally mellow out so that they and their doctors can work jointly to stop the suffering that's making a hash of their lives.
So it's clearly an issue that means a lot to these patients.
So states shouldn't toke their time with this policy. We'd be upset if patients had to wait a long time.
This is the Onion News Network.
We are back with more Free Talk Live as we launch into the second hour of the program. The We tonight includes me, Ian.
And me, Mark.
And we've been talking about your rights, which have been preserved a little bit by the Supreme Court in the United States in a decision on last week's Tuesday. The Daily Dot.com has the story about the good news. 6-2 decision by the Supreme Court saying that you cannot be forced to wait on the side of the road for a drug dog to arrive on the scene to search, to give you a search, if there's no reasonable suspicion that you've committed a crime. And if a cop has reasonable suspicion, then they probably won't have to ask you to search. I'm not a legal expert, I'm not a lawyer, but generally, if a cop has what they need to search as far as suspicion or probable cause is concerned, they'll just go ahead and conduct the search. If they are asking you to search, or asking you to wait around for a drug dog, then that's not legal.
But it makes sure that you point out that what asking sounds like when it comes from the police doesn't always sound like asking.
Yeah, sometimes it sounds like an order.
I'm going to have to ask you to step out of the car right now.
I'm going to have to ask to search your car right now. So these are things that they'll say, and you can always ask for clarification as to what that officer has just told you. And in fact, we're going through a list here from the Daily Dot with where they teamed up with the ACLU and Ezekiel Edwards, their director of the Criminal Law Reform Project, to get some suggestions. They put out there real clear, this is not legal advice. These are suggestions, some ideas as to how you might want to approach a situation like this. And they do suggest that you refuse any kind of search that is offered by the police. I would suggest that you record any scene, ideally with a dash cam like the Freedom Cam.
Freedomcam.net. I have one in both of my vehicles.
And also hold up your own camera on your cell phone. That way you've got two video feeds.
Never a bad idea to have a backup.
What's going on? If you've got a passenger with you, let them do the recording while you do the fiddling with your wallet and your ID and things like that.
I would also say that the nice thing about a dash cam is that it doesn't have that confrontational feel that pulling out your the camera can have.
That's true.
People, many people, probably even most people, are confrontation averse, and they don't want to pull out their phone and get it recording. Especially have some app like Bambuser or whatever it is. What are the other ones?
That's the best one. There's a Ustream one too, I think, but Bambuser is the best, hands down.
Bambuser, which live streams to the internet, so it can't be destroyed or erased or whatever off your phone. They just don't want to do that. Like, they're like, oh, I don't think the situation warrants it quite yet or whatever. And by the time it does warrant it, it's usually too late. Well, that's why a dash cam is really awesome.
Well, do keep in mind, though, that if you have a dash cam, you really ought to know the laws in your area as far as recording without notice. Some states are what are called a single-party consent state, which means as long as one party to a conversation knows there's a recording happening, it's not considered wiretapping. But in certain states, unfortunately, New Hampshire is one of these states, it's a two-party consent or an all-party consent, wherein all parties must be aware that a recording is happening. And some would argue that the law, depending on how the laws are written, they have to consent. But in my opinion, if I inform you that you're being recorded and you continue to talk at that point, that you are consenting to being recorded. That's my opinion. That's not necessarily a legal fact.
There's certainly rulings from circuit courts that back you up on that. It's public servants on public property.
Yeah, for sure.
Doing the public's bidding, getting paid public money. They can be recorded.
So just to be clear, according to the Daily Dot and the ACLU, the Rodriguez ruling by the Supreme Court last week did not outlaw the use of drug-sniffing dogs, only prolonging a traffic stop to use them. A officer could still walk a dog around your car while the other officer issues you a ticket. So this isn't a guarantee, but it does extend your rights a little bit, the protection of your rights just a little bit. Unfortunately, if your rights are being violated, there's little you can do about it in the moment. A good attorney will tell you that challenging the officer's authority in any kind of threatening way or just driving off because you're legally entitled to isn't your best option. Indeed,
yes,
said Edward, it is probably your worst one. The advice is to comply, even when the cops are violating your rights. Outrageous as that is, people should not aggressively challenge their authority in those circumstances. The police abuse of that authority and of your rights is going to have to be settled later. However, even though you shouldn't necessarily try to stop them from illegally searching you, you should record the situation. As long as you aren't in handcuffs at that time, you should absolutely record that situation. And even if you are in handcuffs, you should at the very least try to hit the start button on the recording before they put you in handcuffs. So at the very minimum, you'll get some audio of what's going on. And then if you're getting audio, whether you're getting audio or video, I think that you also want to consider speaking during this, like letting it be known. Officer, I don't consent to your search. Sir, you are searching my car right now, and I just want to let you know I did not consent to that search. That way it's real clear, crystal clear for anybody who's watching that video that you did not agree to that, that you weren't tricked into it or something like that. So keep that in mind as well. Whether you're video or audio recording, that makes it clear. And you can also say, during, you know, sort of narrate the search, right?
Yeah, narrate it.
Officer so-and-so is now, you know, going through my possessions in the back seat or whatever.
Yep. All the narration helps to show your frame of mind at a given time.
Right. So going on
and
here.
Good officers want this. They want the recording because it shows that they were doing the right thing at any given time.
A good officer won't be searching your car, in my opinion.
That's as you define a good officer, but they define themselves differently.
Edwards, the ACLU guy, says, in many ways, police are going to do what they're going to do. If you're arrested and charged with a crime, you would have to raise their violations of the Constitution in the context of your defense by challenging the lawfulness of your arrest or to suppress any evidence seized as a result of such violations, and could eventually try to hold them accountable in a civil lawsuit for money damages. All is not lost, however, and there are proactive steps that you can take. It may be difficult in the moment, but there are several factors you should try to focus on, particularly the time. When did you get stopped? How long did it take them to write the ticket? When did the stop end? How long did you have to wait when they were bringing the dog? Additionally, you have the right to ask the officers for their badge numbers. Whether the search was, and if you've got video, that really helps with all the time frame stuff, and it's not just your opinion versus the officer. Whether the search was legitimate or not, you're probably going to jail now, if they found drugs, that is, during this search. It's crucial at this juncture that you remember that you don't have to answer any interrogating questions. And by the way, point of fact, as they mentioned earlier, you don't have to answer their questions earlier either. Even after, as soon as they walk up to your window, do you know why I pulled you over? You don't have to answer that question. You can just hand to them your driver's license and your, you know, registration and insurance if that's required, and you can say, I'd like to remain silent.
Yeah, the best choice for you, every attorney will tell you this, is simply do not speak to the police. Now, sometimes you have to speak, but certainly don't answer questions. But remember, when you refuse, you know, they can use the tone of your voice, the way you looked at them, all kinds of things, you know, in their investigation. Take a few minutes. If you don't believe me, take a few minutes. Go on YouTube, search in, should I talk to the police? Talk to the police or whatever. I'll bet you come up with several videos from attorneys and ex-police officers say never speak to the police. I've watched them. They've convinced me.
There are seizures of contraband every day that are in violation of the Fourth Amendment, says Edwards. He says, call a lawyer or request one when you're arraigned rather than talking to police. Unfortunately, in those circumstances, you can't do anything about the fact that they've now found drugs or have now put you in handcuffs.
And that is how that is.
And what you're going to try to explain to the lawyer who's defending you is that they have an argument to suppress the drugs, and without the drugs, there's nothing they can charge you with. It's called fruit of the poison tree, as I understand it, which is that they do something illegal in order to garner evidence against you for something. Mm-hmm. That evidence is the fruit of the poison tree, and it should be thrown out in court. Of course,
that's
that doesn't get you out of jail.
This Rodriguez fella.
Yeah.
Well, nothing happens instantly, that's for sure.
They falsified evidence against me. Well, one consequence of the war on drugs is some police officers have abused their authority in the context of searches.
And we don't know how many.
Unofficial arrest quotas, such as those disclosed by former officers in New York City, have incentivized the practice of planting narcotics on innocent people to facilitate arrests. Likewise, cops may erroneously claim they had probable cause to perform a search when none existed. There are things one can try to do to protect their rights in the moment, but if a police officer is dead set on violating your rights and lying about what happened, then you're going to have to fight that out in a legal setting.
And they're
Edwards.
Incredibly powerful individuals.
Right, because they've got attorneys on their side and they don't have to pay anything extra for them. There's more coming up here in moments. 855-450-FREE. And if you're going to get an attorney, the public defender's probably not going to be much of a help to you. In fact, a lot of those guys just want you to take a plea deal, so watch out for them. And just don't take their advice as gold, I guess. Be very suspicious and question everything, even from the attorneys. More coming up. Free Talk Live.
Here's a special message for those of you who owe the IRS at least $10,000 or more in back taxes. The IRS has special programs in place that could eliminate or reduce your tax debt by thousands of dollars. Call the tax helpline that has been set up to help you. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. Stop the wage garnishments, levies, and tax liens now. Once you've qualified and enrolled, the IRS will stop all the collection activities against you. These unique programs have been allocated to help the economy and significantly reduce or eliminate your tax burden. The IRS is currently accepting reduced settlements and other favorable programs. You may qualify for substantial savings, so get the help you need. For free information and to see if you qualify, take down the number now for the Tax Representation Hotline. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. 800-691-6129.
Gold, it's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2233 for the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website or idea, email me, mark@freetalklive.com.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, you may join us here on the radio waves. Maybe you've got a story about a police search. Maybe it went well, meaning that your rights weren't violated too badly. You managed to get out of it without them actually conducting the search. Or maybe they illegally searched you and things either resulted in criminal charges or you managed to get away from the scene. Whatever you want to tell, if you got a story to share with us, please join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. If you'd like to bring something else up entirely, you can do that too. It is Free Talk Live, hence the name. That's what we call the show Free Talk Live 4. You can call in and talk about anything you want. And also, you don't want to be calling in on a dead battery on a cell phone. It could be really embarrassing if you're on hold or in the middle of a conversation and your phone dies.
And it just drops off.
Yeah, so you need to have a good battery charge. And one of the ways you can do that to ensure that you're always charged up is with the Pocket Power Plus. It's a source of backup power that's so small, you can put it right in your pocket, for real. Or right in your glove box or briefcase or purse, whatever it is you're, you know, wherever it is you're going to be, you're going to want the Pocket Power Plus nearby because it will not only charge your cell phone, but it'll also charge your laptop. And in some circumstances, this thing is so powerful, it can actually jumpstart a car. In fact, the Pocket Power Plus can deliver an enormous supply of on-demand power. It's got a full accessory pack with most adapters you'll need, including jumper cables. I mean, if you've seen these battery packs for phones before, they usually don't come with jumper cables.
And that's because they're not designed to do that.
Right, that's because the Pocket Power Plus is a breakthrough in portable power technology. So go and check it out at PocketPowerPlus9.com. You can get it for half price there. And if you use coupon code FTL, you'll save even more. That's PocketPowerPlus9.com. Coupon code FTL. PocketPowerPlus9.com. As we continue here, we'll take your calls about anything that's on your mind. I believe we have David in Mississippi, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes.
On right. Skype. Go ahead, David.
Hey, guys. What's up?
What's on your mind?
So you were talking about people getting searched and stuff.
Yes.
Okay, so here in Lafayette County, Mississippi, we've had a couple stories come out where the BuzzFeed News picked it up, where kids who are getting caught with pot or you know whatever are getting turned into confidential informants.
Oh yeah,
and there's about probably 30 or more of these college kids getting turned into CIs.
And a lot of times, these people will get hurt terribly.
Yeah. There's only four guys on the Metro Narcotics Unit here, and they've got like 30 or 40 kids.
They've got that many snitches, huh?
Yeah, they've got about that many. And one time before it was the Metro Unit, when they were the county and the city and the university were all separate entities for their narcotics, I was at school, and they I was 17 at the time. This is 10 years ago. And they searched me. They thought, oh, he's here selling drugs. And I had some rolling papers in my car, but that was it. I didn't have any drug paraphernalia of any kind, but they tried to get me on that one.
Really? Just for having rolling papers?
Yeah, well, we're in Mississippi, man.
Is it illegal?
That's how it used to be when I was a kid, too. Kids didn't, like, it's kind of hip now to roll your own cigarettes compared to the way it used to be. But
well, I know that in New Hampshire, it's illegal for a teenager under 18 to have cigarettes, but I didn't know it was illegal in some places to actually have the implements that could create a cigarette. So possession of rolling papers is a crime in Mississippi?
No, not at all.
So what
did
they do to you?
I was 17. I didn't know anything. Well, he was trying to recruit me. You know, but when he realized I was 17, he realized he had to talk to my parents, and my parents weren't having any of that.
So let me just make sure I'm clear on this. You went to high school. You're parked in the parking lot there. They searched your car because, well, they can do that stuff on a high school parking lot, basically.
It was after hours, and it was after I had already graduated. I was there because the band director was leaving, and I was going to this.
Then you may actually have a legal case in that case if it's not during school hours. That would be an interesting test case. So they searched your car. They find you got. By the way, you got to watch your breathing there. It's there's a lot of
you got no windscreen on your mic.
There's a lot of wind going in that microphone. So you are searched. You're not actually at the – it's not during school hours. You'd already graduated. They went ahead and searched you anyway without your consent?
Yeah, no consent. They had they said whatever. And I was 17. I didn't know any better.
So wait, was the car wide open? Did they just start pawing through it? Or was the door locked? Did you let them in? How did that work?
I let them in because I didn't know any better.
So that is consent then. I mean, even though you didn't know any better, that you did essentially agree to the search.
Yeah, but they were pulling my panels off and stuff. It was ridiculous.
Oh yeah. Right. They're serious. This is the one thing that people really need to understand is when you consent to a police officer searching your car, there's not the sure you can just look, check in the seat crack
whatever they want.
They will tear the panels off of your car, rip up your carpets if they feel like
they
it.
They could.
They may not do that. Throw your spare tire out on the road. You know, do whatever the heck they want to do, and then you'll clean it up.
And so then they find rolling papers in your car, and then they want to intimidate you into becoming an informant based on the fact you had rolling papers.
Yeah, but I was 17, so they couldn't get me to consent.
Wow,
I lucked out there.
And good thing
they
you had parents
intimidate
who,
my dad.
Yeah, good thing you had cool parents who weren't going to go along with that crap.
Yeah, well, they weren't too happy about having found carton cigarettes.
Exactly. What?
Papers,
what were the rolling papers and cigarettes doing there, son?
But it beats
dealing with the police.
Good story, David. Thank you for the call tonight. I appreciate it. Let's continue here. Let's go to Brian calling from I don't know where. Brian, where are you tonight?
I'm in San Diego.
Brian, you're on Free Talk Live via Skype. Go ahead.
Hey, I just thought I'd call in. I just had criticisms.
We love that. Go ahead.
I'm an ANCAP, and I often hear this idea about...
ANCAP stands for anarcho-capitalist.
Yeah.
Yes. Okay, go ahead.
And so I always hear this idea about that value subjective, and I just reject that idea. It just sounds absurd to me.
That value is subjective?
Yeah.
Subjective. So you're saying value is objective, meaning that everything has a specific value, whatever that is?
Yes.
Okay. Please explain to me, because it doesn't make it, that statement does not make any sense.
Yeah, I'm having a hard time with it.
So you mean the latter one doesn't make any sense?
Your statement that everything has an objective value makes no sense to me. That's right.
I believe that the phenomenon of subjectivity is actually, it comes from poor definition. So anytime you poorly define something, it kind of leaves room for interpretation, which leads to what you call subjectivity.
Okay.
Does that kind of intuitively make any sense to you?
Yeah.
Can you give me more of an example?
Yeah, that makes sense, but it's not. You're going to have to go further to explain it to me.
So if I'm right, if I were to have you refine your term of whatever you're talking about that you think is subjective, I can actually pinpoint. I can actually pigeonhole you into. An objective value to what you're actually referring to. But as far as subjective value is concerned, I think it actually relates to value of a good to a consumer. Would you agree with that?
So subjective value is a good to a consumer? It couldn't be a service?
It's the value of a good to a consumer.
So we're not talking about a service?
That's a good.
A service is good. Okay.
All right, stand by. I want to get into this here because it seems to me that value is only something that can be obtained when a deal is made, that until a buyer and seller agree on a price and terms, that we don't know really what the value is. 855-450-FREE. It's Free Talk Live.
Friends, this is Alex Jones for MidasResources.com. For more than 15 years, I have exclusively used Midas Resources for all my precious metal needs. Whether it's bullion or collectibles you're looking for, Midas Resources is simply the best. I own my gold as a hedge against inflation. This Federal Reserve fiat currency could go the way of the Deutschmark and the Weimar Republic anytime. In these historically dangerous times, it makes sense to physically hold gold and silver. Midas already has some of the best deals in the industry. But if you give them a call and mention the radio special, they will give you a list of the day's super specials. Midas brokers are standing by to answer all your questions at 800-686-2237. They also have a lot of informative free literature explaining the opportunities and risk of holding precious metals. They are ready to answer your questions at 800-686-2237. Again, that's 800-686-2237.
Are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenvention. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year's keynote speeches and panels will be announced via the Keenvention blog and Facebook, so stay tuned there for the latest. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 30th through November 1st. Tickets are available now at a special early bird price of just $50 via credit card or Bitcoin. That $50 price only lasts through the end of June, so don't delay. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more and look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info. When I found the Free State Project, I knew it was the key to achieving liberty in my lifetime. It's awesome to be surrounded by like-minded, freedom-loving activists who've moved here to New Hampshire. From politics to civil disobedience, we have it all. Where I came from, it felt that no matter what I did, liberty was dying. Perhaps you feel the same way? Call 888-377-2515 now to learn more about the Free State Project. That's 888-377-2515 or visit freestateproject.org. You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
Cato University is the Cato Institute's premier educational event of the year. It's being held this year from July the 26th to the 31st at the Cato Institute's state-of-the-art headquarters in Washington, D.C. This annual program brings together outstanding faculty and participants from across the country and often from around the globe, with everyone sharing a commitment to liberty and learning. Cato University is a genuine community, and you can freely share viewpoints, concerns, ideas, questions, and more in an atmosphere of friendship and personal respect. It's a one-of-a-kind program for people who don't stop thinking after they got out of school. It's for people who don't want politicians or bureaucrats or officials to do their thinking for them. It's for people who value liberty. You'll learn, you'll be inspired, you'll make new friends, you'll meet great people from around the world. All of the details are spelled out at the Cato website, cato.org, and they hope to see you there this summer, July the 26th through the 31st in Washington, D.C. Again, details are at cato.org.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial toll-free to join us here, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. With you tonight, Ian here.
And Mark.
And I want to tell you about how to get Bitcoin. ExpressCoin is the best choice for getting your cryptocurrencies. Not just Bitcoin, they've got Litecoin, Dogecoin. It's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. They're a licensed money services business. Whether you want a little bit or a lot of Bitcoin, they can help you out over there. Just start off at ExpressCoin.com. Whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, you can get cryptocurrency with money order or check. It's ExpressCoin.com. You can now do it from your smartphone by downloading their app. ExpressCoin.com has it. And plus, you can use coupon code FTL and you'll save up to up to $40 worth of Bitcoin. So if you buy less than $40 worth, then there's no transfer fee. There's no fee involved in that process. Whereas normally it's a very, very low fee with ExpressCoin, and it's probably the best in the industry that I've seen.
That's how they made their chops.
Yep. So ExpressCoin.com. Don't forget coupon code FTL. I've used them. ExpressCoin.com. So our toll-free number here again is 855-450-FREE. We're talking about your rights in general, and I want to come back around to the discussion about police searches. There's a little bit more from the ACLU to share on that topic. about your rights on the side of the road. But let's continue here with Brian, who is on the line via Skype. Now, Brian, what you said earlier was kind of a surprise. I'd never heard this before, I don't think.
Yeah, this is it sounds ludicrous to me, but I've heard ludicrous things on the air that I have then adopted into my belief system later. So I am interested to hear what you have to say.
So you're saying value is not subjective, that value of an item or a service is objective.
Yes.
But that seems to go contrary to how value tends to work, which is that you don't ultimately know what the value of something is until the deal is done.
I just think that I think this all came from Rothbard. Maybe I'm mistaken, but this whole idea of subjective value, maybe it came from one of his books or something. But it seems that the libertarian movement's kind of grasped onto this.
Okay.
Fallaciously. But anyways, you just have to be careful what you're referring to. Subjective means it's determined by the mind. You kind of agree with that rough definition there.
Okay.
So you're claiming
said that it's different for each person, but okay.
Yeah. So. I don't.
Well, there's both definitions. I'd like to point out. I just looked it up. Definition one, existing in the mind, belonging to the thinking subject. Definition two, pertaining to or characteristic of an individual.
Okay, and which
so
one?
So if something is subjective, then two different individuals can have differing opinions about that thing, right? So one product, a product, let's pick, I've got a Skyhook Bitcoin vending machine that cost me $1,000 worth of Bitcoin initially, but if I were to sell that as a used product, there would likely be differing opinions about what that is worth, wouldn't there?
Sure, of course. In order for a transaction to happen, there has to be a different value for each person in the transaction, right? The seller has to value it less than the buyer in order for the transaction to happen.
Yep. And the buyer has to, if you're buying a hamburger for a dollar, you have to value the hamburger more than you value the dollar in order to make the buy.
Of course. So, the thing is, that's their opinion of it, right? So, as far as your opinion is concerned, just going back to subjectivity, even your subjective opinion is objective. Does that make any sense?
Or no,
does that sound contradictory? So, the fallacy here is you think that subjectivity and objectivity are mutually exclusive, right? So there's no object in reality that can be both at the same time. You think they're...
I don't know about that, but okay.
Yeah, that's a fallacy.
Okay.
Subjectivity is a subset of objectivity. I can refer to your opinion. I can actually determine your opinion if you tell me what it is, right? So in a way, it's objective.
Yeah, that makes sense. Sure, yep.
So you see that they're not mutually exclusive. Actually, one's a subset of the other.
I could see where you're coming from on that.
So just in that,
my opinion can change as well, right? Arbitrarily.
Sure. So, but if you give me a time, if I restrict it to a time coordinate, then it can't, right? So if I say,
okay,
what's your opinion at
my
this
opinion
time?
At this time is something. Yep. Okay.
So you see, just on that technicality, I've already proven my point, but that's not what the intent is.
I don't think you have.
No, because there are other people with other opinions, right?
No, but I've just proven that all opinion subject is both subjective and objective.
An objective price on something, because that's what we're talking about here, is pricing.
No,
essentially, we're not talking about pricing.
No, price is not price. Price lies between seller's value and buyer's value. Remember, price is not value. Right. Price is always going to be in between.
Well,
those two.
So if the seller, seller's
technical.
Value.
It's real technical, but. But it makes sense, right?
I see where you're coming from. I mean,
but I mean, a price is an agreed upon value between at the very least two people.
It's a negotiated price, and it'll get closer to one of the other values based upon bargaining power.
Yeah, right?
But you're admitting that there are two different values involved, right? Like the two people involved, the buyer and the seller, have two different values in mind, and the price is somewhere between those two. So by admitting that there are two different values, doesn't that mean that they're subjective, meaning that in each individual there exists a different value for something?
Yeah, that wasn't my that wasn't my definition of subjective when I was coming to it. That's actually confusing subjectivity with relativity. Subjectivity has to do with the mind. But I heard that alternate definition, which is more relativity than subjectivity. But
I just want to, in the dictionary. So.
Well, one of the problems with dictionary definitions is that they evolve over time. Like if people continue to use the term subjective in order to refer to the term relative, then it will be at some point or another defined by the dictionary as, you know, they'll use the term for relative to define subjective.
So would you then say from your perspective that value is relative?
Yes, which is objective.
And objective. Okay, yes. That's interesting.
Okay,
so I want to distinguish between opinion and value, value.
So this is a semantic conversation. Would you agree with this?
The non-semantic part of it is I can ask you your interpretation of subjective value was opinion is value, correct?
I think that I sort of said something in order to get you to keep on going, but, for me, what I'm thinking of opinion as, more than one person's opinion, not the individual's opinion.
Yeah.
And so I get where you're coming from.
What's your opinion of the value of this good to you when you buy it?
Yep. I think that the term subjective is used so often to mean the term relative that at this point it is almost worth using the term subjective to mean relative.
I'm asking for the distinction between opinion and value.
Yes, you're asking for the right, but I mean a value to some extent is based on opinion, and the
is there any distinction there though?
Opinion and value?
Yeah, because if you say no, then it's the first definition of what Ian said, right?
As long as you're coming at something with the same definitions, you can have a conversation. I think we've been able to have a conversation about this, and you've made your points. Thank you for the call, Brian. I appreciate it. Toll-free number here, 855-450-FREE. I don't know if I've been convinced to accept a different definition of subjective, however.
Yeah, I mean, it's a...
Because that's what I would have to do.
Free Talk Live is a great place for semantic conversations. Yeah. At this point, what I have seen is that there are two definitions of subjective.
Right, and that's what I would have to do to accept his idea that... value is objective is to accept his definition as subjective or of subjective.
Yeah. Right?
So the toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. We are also going to continue and discuss a little bit more on the Daily Dots story with the ACLU and their advice, or excuse me, not their advice. It's not legal advice, as they've pointed out. It's just an article full of suggestions that were written by an attorney. How about that?
Yeah, that's right.
So there's a little bit more from that story. I want to get into that here. And then there's, I don't know if you heard about the headlines from the mainstream media, Mark, about the Crips and the Bloods targeting police officers in Baltimore. Did you see those headlines?
No, I didn't.
Yeah, those were around yesterday. And earlier today, there's a story that's come out, and John Vibes over at the Free Thought Project is reporting on it. And he's actually there in Baltimore. Turns out, what the mainstream media has been saying about the Crips and the Bloods just isn't true. And we'll share with you the shocking truth here in a moment.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
Hi, John Huebner from Midas Resources. Are you tired of watching your hard-earned assets dwindle away? As government spending is out of hand and the Federal Reserve is creating in excess of $20 billion a week, are you tired of stockbrokers gambling away your hard-earned money? Is this market a setup for a crash greater than 1987? Too many of today's policies resemble those that led to the collapse of 1929. This is John Huebner, and that was me in 2007.
And we all know what happened when the subprime credit bubble burst. By March 2009, the dollar lost 50% of its value. The entire U.S. banking system was on the verge of collapsing. Like all financial problems of the past, is history about to repeat itself? Call me, John Huebner, at 1-800-686-2237, extension 129, before it's too late to protect yourself. Will the oncoming catastrophe take all private IRAs, 401ks with it? There is a way to protect your hard-earned assets. Call me, John Huebner, at 1-800-686-2237. 6-2-2-3-7, extension 129.
This week, the Forest Service rolled out a brand new Smokey the Bear campaign in which the popular mascot burns to death. They say they hope the shocking turn will get people serious about preventing forest fires for once. The new campaign depicts Smokey the Bear noticing a family leave a flame unattended. Before he can put it out, the entire forest is consumed and Smokey dies in agony while trying to fight the blaze. Despite educating the public for over 70 years, the Forest Service says wildfires have only gotten worse and it was time to take their warnings to the next level. The new ads aim to show that if Smokey the Bear can be killed by the very type of fire he works so tirelessly to prevent, it could happen to anyone at any time. So what's next for the long-running campaign? Well, now that their primary spokesperson is out of the picture, the ad council says the PSAs will shift focus to a new character named Little Brian. He's the boy whose family caused the fire in the first place, and he's grappling with crippling guilt over Smokey's death.
This is the Onion News Network.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Lil Drums. Every bit as fun as a full-size Nestle drumstick cone and definitely cuter. Visit us at drumstick.com. Vacations are all about family time, but you don't have to leave home to have fun. Take one weekend a month and devote it to family activities. Pull out the board games and puzzles, serve up some treats, or have a picnic. Even without leaving home, you'll feel like you've really had some time away. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
We're back with Free Talk Live. You, of course, can dial in toll-free. Share whatever you want with us here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you tonight, it's Ian.
And Mark.
Don't forget, if you want to support Free Talk Live, you can do that by contributing to our fundraiser. We're trying to get Free Talk Live and the dozens of other excellent liberty-oriented shows that appear on LRN.FM back on satellite over Africa. The idea is there are a lot of people, millions of them in Africa, that don't have internet access. I don't know, maybe even like a billion. I don't know how many people there are in Africa, but I imagine there's quite a few. And a bunch of them don't have internet access. So they have to get information somehow. People still desire to be entertained and be informed. And that is one of the things that we can do with getting LRN on free-to-air satellite over Africa. Free-to-air meaning they can receive it without paying a monthly subscription.
I don't know how many people are in Africa. I do know how many people are in Africa now, but I didn't know how many was before I started punching these numbers in. And then I realized this is an agreed upon lie, right? Like, they don't know how many people are in Africa.
No, how could they?
There's, you know, the people.
What's the estimate?
1.11 million. Billion, excuse me. Yeah.
Yeah. So anyway, the idea being that this free-to-air is easy to receive. Lots of people there already have the dishes and the receivers. They're just waiting to hear what we have to say. And we already have fans there because we've already been on in Africa, and they would love to keep listening. So it's going to cost some money, though. It's $22,000 for 3 years worth of broadcasting. When you break it down per month, it's really only several hundred dollars per month. And so if you want to help us with that, please go to africa.lrn.fm and contribute whatever you can afford. That's africa.lrn.fm. And then share it. Most importantly, share the video, share the link. And maybe we'll get some last-minute contributions here. We've still got about 3 weeks left in the campaign. So thank you to everyone who has helped and everyone who has yet to do so and will be doing so at africa.lrn.fm. Back to the story here from the Daily Dot at dailydot.com about the ACLU and their opinion on what to do, not legal advice, they say, just some suggestions on how to handle police searches, the demands by the police on the side of the road, illegal actions by the police on the side of the road, and they finally do get to my idea of recording toward the very end of this article here, but we're almost to that point. Here's the remainder of the story from DailyDot.com. There are things that one can do to try to protect your rights in the moment, but if a police officer is dead set on violating your rights and lying about what happened, then you're going to have to fight that out in a legal setting. Sometimes you can be vindicated, and sometimes not. It's not an ideal situation. Again, you should always make clear that you know what your rights are. Ask the police for explanations about what they're doing. Get badge numbers, as there's the right to record the police, so long... Oh, and he says, and... There's the right to record the police as long as you're not interfering with their work. And if you are on a scene and you are the victim of the police pullover, I don't think they can argue very effectively in court later that you were interfering with them by recording the contents of the the contents of the interaction. One hope is that the adoption of on-officer body cameras will help curb police abuse. These devices come with a deluge of privacy-related issues, which lawmakers are currently debating in several states, but they're slowly becoming the norm in several major U.S. cities. And I say that's a good thing. I realize there are some people out there who would disagree with me on that. In fact, I believe some folks over at CopBlock.org disagree on this particular issue, and I'm a huge CopBlock supporter. I just think more cameras better. I understand that the police having cameras could be used against people. There's no doubt about that. It does have an objective record of whatever it is that happened. So it is true that police having body cameras will lead to people being convicted of things that they might otherwise not have been convicted of. You know, for instance, you wouldn't be able to recall a conversation in a different way if there's an objective record of that conversation, if that conversation is against your freedoms, if you, you know, admitted to something that you shouldn't have admitted to. The cops will then have the evidence of you admitting to that.
That's true.
So it is going to help them in some cases. But in other cases where they do abuse people's rights and they, you know, they don't turn off the camera beforehand, it will help the people who've been abused. And we've seen instances of police wearing body cameras who've been abusive towards people. And it's a good thing the camera was there.
Yeah, sometimes it's useful.
But I think the most important thing to caution is you can't expect that should be the only camera. If the cops, let's say the cops in your area adopt these body cameras, don't breathe a sigh of relief and feel like you've been relieved from having to have the responsibility of recording a scene. That should not lessen your feeling of responsibility. When I get pulled over, whether I'm in a passenger in a vehicle or driving, I feel it is my obligation to record that situation to make sure that an objective record exists. With the police, you can't trust them to have an objective record. You can't trust that they're going to turn the camera on. You can't trust that they're going to retain the footage afterward. They might accidentally lose it.
More than once.
It might end up being corrupted mysteriously somehow. Oh, well, I thought it was recording, but it turns out the battery died. I mean, there's all kinds of things they could say. And so you've got to make sure that you take full responsibility for recording a scene.
Yeah, you have to believe sort of in the department, as it were, and you know, sometimes the police officer and everybody makes mistakes, right? Everybody steps out of the line and doing their jobs. I know I have. You know, it might be his good friend that runs the department that handles all the audio and video. He's like, hey, Jim, can you cut me a little slack on this one and lose that file or whatever? And, you know, it's gone.
And there won't be any penalty for them for losing it either, by the way.
Or if it's really important to him, his camera could get dropped in the water or whatever.
In the end, says the ACLU's expert, making sure police are well-trained and work well within the community is the primary way to ensure your rights are not violated. He says, quote, the police need to be, more than anybody, comprehensively, effectively, and consistently trained in what the Fourth Amendment is. They need to know when they can and can't stop you, when they can and can't continue holding you, and that if somebody refuses to give consent to a search, they have to abide by that refusal, assuming they don't have any other suspicion. So there you go. That's some ideas from the ACLU. Just a recap for those of you who are just tuning in. The Supreme Court came out with a 6-2 decision last week. It's a pretty good decision that says that police officers cannot prolong a traffic stop beyond how long it takes to write that ticket for the reason they stopped you without further reasonable suspicion that they would need to bring a drug dog in. So if they're just pulling you over for a speeding ticket and you didn't have a cloud full of marijuana smoke roll out of the vehicle when you rolled the window down, then they, in theory, would have to let you go after the ticket is written. Don't just sit around and wait. Don't let them talk you into a search or wait around for the drug dog. Ask if you're free to leave. Am I free to go? And you can ask that at any time. More than once.
Keep asking it. Yeah. Ask it to the first thing.
This isn't legal advice. This is just suggestions.
But if to point out that this may just cause more funding when it comes to police is if you get pulled over by a canine unit with two officers in it, one officer can write you a ticket while the other one spends his time going around your car with a dog.
Yeah, that's true.
So this doesn't stop dogs from being used in sort of car searches.
In which case, you could solve that problem by moving to Keene, New Hampshire, where there are no drug dogs. There's a dog. They have a dog. The dog's name is Patriot here in Keene, but the dog is trained at finding people, not drugs. So that's kind of a neat little tidbit about our
like
Keene.
In case something collapses?
No, well, maybe that, but a missing child or something like that. You know, you get the child's pillow, the dog smells the pillow, and then they, you know, let him run off in the woods and find the kid. You know, that kind of thing. Or like a cadaver searching dog as well. So they actually train dogs for different purposes. Usually, I don't believe it's – I could be wrong on this, but my understanding is that dogs can't be cross-trained very effectively at all. So that's why the body-sniffing dog only sniffs bodies, and the drug-sniffing dog sniffs for drugs.
Yeah, that would have been my thought. You know, they certainly have a lot of those dogs that hunt for people at prisons and those sorts of things. So you can get that – usually police departments get their dogs on loan in those circumstances from the prisons.
So you can share your thoughts with us. Maybe you've got a story about your search or maybe your successful refusal of a search and how that went. How did the officer treat you? When a cop asks you to search, it means they don't have probable cause. They need your permission. So when you say no, what kind of behavior does that elicit from an officer? I imagine there's quite a range. You know, there could be there's likely the type of officer who will be dejected that they've run across someone who knows their rights. And in fact, if you are the kind of person who asserts your rights up front, you know, like by asking what the officer's badge number is and holding up a video camera, that alone may be enough to dissuade that officer from even asking you to search.
Because it's usually not worth the trouble at that point.
Because it's clear to that officer, this is not an easy mark. This is someone who knows their rights.
But some officers will take it as a challenge, and they've got nothing better to do in many cases. You know, there's only crimes being committed elsewhere, and they're not going to be able to find them until they're reported anyway, because police really aren't crime prevention units. They are the cleanup crew that comes and writes the reports after it all happened. And, well, they just got to wait until they get the call.
Coming up on Free Talk Live, Mark, you've got a Facebook note that you wanted to share with us from someone talking about scams in the free market.
That's right.
And I want to get to that, but also the Bloods and the Crips story out of Baltimore was all over the media yesterday, probably today as well, about how the Bloods and the Crips are teaming up to kill cops. And turns out the Bloods and the Crips are teaming up, but not for that reason. We'll explain. There's truce going on between these gangs. What's it all about? It's happening in Baltimore. We'll tell you more coming up in moments on Free Talk Live at 855 450 free.
Growth can be an intimidating six-letter word, especially when the guys upstairs want 7% of it. That's why you need one eight-letter word, Grainger. Grainger. The G is for growth. From industry specialists to over 1 million products across almost every category, Grainger has the resources to help us grow. Now, can you guess what my favorite four-letter word is? WORK. Let's get back to it. Get it? Got it? Good. Call clickgrainger.com or stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Geico Motorcycle presents Reflections from the Road.
Let me tell you, the road is a much more relaxing place since I switched to Geico Motorcycle Insurance and started saving money. With that taken care of, now I can think about deep, important things. Like how come it's a pair of pants when there's only one of them? A real brain teaser. But hey, at least saving money with Geico Motorcycle is as easy as pie. What does that mean, anyway?
Geico Motorcycle Insurance. See how much you could save.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, April 28th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.58 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,206 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $226. Antiwar.com reports during the brief summer Israeli war against the Gaza Strip, Israeli forces repeatedly attacked UN facilities, particularly schools that they knew for a fact were full of displaced civilians. The UN inquiry expressed dismay at the Israeli strikes, noting they killed 44 Palestinian civilians and wounded 227 others in attacks on emergency shelters. Israel has defended the attacks, insisting that other closed schools were being used to hide weapons. Oddly, those sites don't appear to have been attacked, and Israel instead hit UN sites that they knew were loaded down with civilians that had just days prior been ordered out of their homes by the Israeli military. Pentagon lawyers issued their own report, and while they insisted they weren't judging specific incidents, they did praise the Israeli military, insisting that the decisions on targets to strike were largely in line with what the U.S. military would have done under the same circumstances. The killings loom large in a potential ICC investigation into Israeli war crimes against civilians in the occupied territories and reflect the continued efforts by the U.S. to keep Israel immune from any consequences for their actions. In Survivor Max by Davi Barker, 11-year-old Max must survive the zombie apocalypse alone in New Hampshire. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the lame brains swarm his home searching for living flesh. Max must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to plan his escape, but first, he must prove that he's too smart to die. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook and Amazon, or read Chapter 1 free at SurvivorMax.com. UPI reports Maryland Governor Larry Hogan declared a state of emergency Monday and deployed the National Guard in response to violent clashes between police and rioters. Demonstrators in Baltimore turned violent after the funeral of Freddie Gray, who died after suffering a broken spine while in police custody. Protesters appeared to hurl items at police, and authorities used pepper spray to try to disperse the crowd. Hogan said the looting and acts of violence in Baltimore will not be tolerated. He added in a statement, "I strongly condemn the actions of the offenders who are engaged in direct attacks against innocent civilians, businesses, and law enforcement officers. There is a significant difference between protesting and violence, and those committing these acts will be prosecuted under the fullest extent of the law." At a news conference held by Baltimore officials Monday evening, Police Colonel Daryl D'Souza said 15 officers were injured, two of them remain hospitalized. CNN reports one of its photographers was also injured and transported to a hospital. There is no report on the number of protesters injured by police.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports a day before the U.S. Supreme Court hears landmark arguments on whether the Constitution provides a right to same-sex marriage. Activists on both sides of the contentious social issue converged on the white marble courthouse to voice their views. Anti-gay rights activists rallied in front of the courthouse steps condemning same-sex marriage, while a line snaked around the block of people, many displaying gay rights messages, hoping to snag one of the limited number of seats available in the courtroom for Tuesday's 2.5-hour oral arguments. The nine justices will be hearing arguments concerning same-sex marriage restrictions imposed in Kentucky, Michigan, Ohio, and Tennessee, four of the 13 states that still outlaw such marriages. The ruling, due by the end of June, will determine whether same-sex marriage will be legal nationwide. At a small Monday morning rally, opponents of same-sex marriage railed against judges who have struck down state same-sex marriage bans. Tuesday's arguments will be divided into two parts. The first, set for 90 minutes, is on whether the Constitution's guarantee of due process and equal protection under the law means states must allow same-sex couples to marry. The second part, scheduled for an hour, concerns whether states must recognize same-sex marriages that take place out of state. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Florida officials announced today its plan to experiment with new 600-lever voting machines.
The machine operates through a very straightforward process that we think is going to give Floridians the peace of mind that their votes will be counted. The voter turns on the machine using these 30 levers at the top and then enters their names and social security numbers using the alphanumeric levers near the bottom here. Right about now, the voter is going to have to find the two levers on the machine that are exactly identical and pull them at the same time. Then they're going to have to...
The new 22-foot-tall steam-powered machines, which officials are hailing as, quote, the future of voting, each feature over 45 separate panels of levers, along with an intricate series of valves, knobs, cranks, and pumps, all designed to streamline the electoral process.
Now, some of this may seem confusing, but every voter will be given a comprehensive 2,200-page manual when they enter their precinct that will explain exactly what to do.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. We will take your calls about anything you want to discuss. Coming up, the Crips and the Bloods are uniting in a truce.
I didn't know they were still around.
Yeah, they're still around.
What do I know?
They're uniting, not as the mainstream media had reported previously, to attack the police, but in point of fact, to defend as much peace as possible, to try to keep the peace. It's a pretty interesting story here from, actually, WBAL ended up reporting on this, but the story is from thefreethoughtproject.com and John Vibes, who actually lives in Baltimore, so he's kind of in the thick of it. But before we get into that, I do want to welcome our newest talk radio affiliate in Owensboro, Kentucky. So welcome to WOMI. It's your home for news, talk, and sports, 99.1 FM and 1490 AM in Owensboro. So welcome aboard to our new listeners who will be getting 1 hour per night of Free Talk Live every night of the weekdays. So welcome. If you're new to the show, you might be a little shocked, might be a little surprised at what you're hearing because it's not your typical kind of cookie cutter conservative talk radio. And it really is open phones, so you really can bring up anything you want. If, let's say, you don't want to talk about what's happening in Baltimore, you can call in and bring up what's on your mind. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, and I'm Ian, by the way.
And I'm Mark.
And so, of course, you can join us on the phones. You can also join us via Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. I got to say, I'm really happy we've had a couple calls on Skype tonight. They've sounded pretty good, all things considered. So here's a story, the latest from Baltimore, at least some of the latest. There's, you know, it's still a developing situation. In fact, I probably have three or four different pieces out of Baltimore tonight, but we're not going to have time to get to them all. But I thought this one was really important because there's a certain mainstream media kind of perspective, which is very much fed by the police department. So whatever it is that the police department says in their press releases and their press conferences tends to be whatever it is that the mainstream media reports. They just take the press release from the police, put their mainstream media headline on it, and almost release it word for word. In a lot of cases, I don't want to indict every media organization and all reporters working for the mainstream sources, but generally, there's not a whole lot of critical thinking. There's not a whole lot of questioning when it comes to journalists and their view of what police say. So when the police came out yesterday and were claiming that the Crips and the Bloods were ganging up to, they're teaming up to go after the cops in Baltimore.
And cops are probably feeling really besieged. There's injured police officers. I believe one person was critically injured or something like that. So they feel besieged, and you know, now's a good time to kind of get the public on their side. I'm seeing a lot of stuff going on Facebook of people sort of saying things to the effect of, "Look at these animals,
meaning
how
the
their
cops?
Behavior." No, they're talking about the citizenry,
the rioters
of you know, it's both sides. I'm seeing all this. One of the quote unquote advantages I have of Facebook is that I've got, you know, friends and family and you know, coworkers from the past and these kinds of folks. I don't generally use my Facebook page as a platform to proselytize libertarianism. Mm-hmm. So I get an opportunity to just sort of see what folks are saying. And a lot of the more conservative folks on my Facebook feed are saying things to the effect of, you know, this is awful. Now,
destruction of property is an awful thing.
I think it's interesting that many conservatives, though, will advocate for resistance to government, even armed resistance in certain circumstances. Hmm. But when that armed resistance actually occurs, and it's done by a group that they just don't like,
then they want to crack down.
Yeah.
Huh?
You know.
So here's a story from the Free Thought Project. The Crips, Bloods, BGF. Can you look that one up, Mark? What's BGF? What does that gang stand for? What is the acronym? I've not heard of that one before.
Nor have I.
Crips, Bloods, BGF, and other major gangs reportedly called a truce during yesterday's Freddie Gray protests in Baltimore. They did not make threats of violence.
Black Gorilla Family.
Thank you for that. They were not indicated as participants in acts of violence or vandalism during the protests. However, their promise to no longer be divided was such a threat to the establishment that within 12 hours, there were stories on the homepage of every mainstream media publication talking about how the gangs were going to join up with the specific intention of killing cops and burning down the city.
Hmm.
Each of the mainstream sources had basically republished a press release that was put out by the Baltimore City Police Department, citing that there was a, quote, credible threat that gang members were planning to carry out attacks on police. There was, however, no evidence to back this claim up, but the very fact that rival gangs were calling a truce in the streets was enough to drive the establishment into panic mode. And this should tell you something. The establishment wants people divided, and they fear other armed and organized groups providing their own communities with defense, effectively challenging the state's monopoly on violence. And we saw this happen with the Oath Keepers, if you recall, during one of the more recent Ferguson episodes of violence in the streets.
Mm-hmm.
Oath Keepers came out, they showed up at businesses and neighborhoods, and they sort of posted themselves on rooftops, if you will, to keep an eye out and try to keep looters at bay. And the police came down on them for it. They came down and they threatened them over this, claiming that they were providing protection services without a license, essentially.
Yeah.
And so that, you know, it's really clear that the police do not want anyone to show them up to do a better job than the police are doing at actually protecting people. So going on here with John Vibes' piece from thefreethoughtproject.com, one thing that's often forgotten is that many of today's street gangs have roots in activist groups that sought to provide protection for communities that were being ignored or oppressed by police. These groups became less organized over the years, lost their way, and turned to corruption. However, this truce could be a positive sign that these groups are returning to their roots and becoming more concerned with protecting their communities. In an interview late Monday night, Crips, Bloods, and members of BGF had the opportunity to set the record straight with Deborah Wiener of WBAL-TV. Wiener was the only mainstream reporter, maybe it's Weiner, I don't know, who cared to explore the other side of the story. In the interview, gang members displayed immense intelligence and understanding for the situation. They stated that they called the truce to protect their communities from violence and looting, and to protect their community from anyone who would put it in danger. They were reportedly attacked by police when they were attempting to defend properties throughout the city from rioters. Mm. So you've got the Crips and the Bloods and BGF and others who have dropped the hostilities between them. They have teamed up and are doing essentially what the Oath Keepers did in Ferguson. They are protecting businesses from being looted.
So the claim goes, I'm kind of left wondering, right? Like, don't you think the people that are most likely to riot are also the sort of people that are most likely to have joined a criminal gang?
Well, that's an interesting suggestion, Mark. But, I mean, these are people who live here. The suggestions in Baltimore...
The rioters don't?
What has been said is that a lot of the people rioting in the streets in Baltimore are not from around there. They're people who've come in, you know, like the Black Bloc or whatever. They've come in from elsewhere knowing that this is a place where they can get into it, into a fracas with the police and destroy things and have relative anonymity in doing so. The people who live in these neighborhoods, they don't want to see their neighborhoods destroyed.
I saw some pretty convincing video of a mother going and grabbing her, what everyone assumes is her son, and beating the heck out of him on camera for having participated in the riot. You know, so that guy, assumably, is from Baltimore mm-hmm. and participating.
I'm not saying there's no one in Baltimore.
I'm not either. I don't know.
I'm not saying that, Mark. I'm saying there is a number of people coming in from outside of the area.
Generally,
people do want to kind of take care of their own neighborhoods.
I would say that, well... I don't know if there's a lot of evidence for that historically when it comes to rioting, that people want to take care of their own neighborhoods. I mean, are you claiming that the Ferguson riots were largely people from outside of Ferguson because they sure, you know, set
their
own neighborhoods?
Honestly, I don't know. I didn't hear anything about the about who was making up those rioters there. So I'm not going to jump to a conclusion. I'm just not – it's not appropriate for me to jump to a conclusion like that.
I can see why people would, you know, now be kind of riot hunting.
Why don't you so you question the gang members' veracity, but you don't question the Oath Keepers? Why is that?
The Oath Keepers versus the gang members? What do you mean?
Yeah.
What part isn't it that the Oath Keepers said that they were going in to protect people?
These guys are saying.
All evidence pointed to that's what they were, in fact, doing.
All the evidence points to that here. That's what
evidence?
They're saying.
Oh, no, saying something isn't the same as doing it. The Oath Keepers did it.
So you're just not believing them, right? You're just because they're in a gang means they're all of a sudden, you know, you can't trust their word?
Just because they're in a criminal gang says that, yes, they're likely to commit
just
criminal
acts. Whoa. How do you know that because they're in a gang means that they're committing criminal acts?
They're the Crips and the Bloods.
Well, you're jumping to conclusions,
yes,
Mark.
Yes, I am!
855 450, and it's not fair. 855-453.
Get out of that gang!
Do you want people to jump to a conclusion that you're a conservative talk show host? That's not fair.
Are you completely free of stress and fatigue? Well, of course not. You aren't alone, though. Now think about how nice it would be to begin relieving some of that stress and fatigue. Let me introduce you to a product that has and is working for me. It's called Youthful Greens. Youthful Greens. It's packed full of nature's nourishing, cleansing, and alkalizing greens, providing a powerful dose of whole food nutrition in each serving. Youthful Greens helps increase overall energy levels and reduce all that fatigue and stress on your body. And right now, when you visit freegreens.net or call 800-333-6923 and order your one-month supply of Youthful Greens for only $29.95, you get another month's supply for free. That's 2 months of Youthful Greens for the already low price of just $29.95, plus free shipping. That's saving you $45. Visit freegreens.net today or simply call 800-333-6923. And hey, you're welcome.
Gold, it's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2233 for the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the Liberty Media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com. LRN.FM needs your help getting our satellite signal back on in Africa. Our satellite provider had us on at no charge from 2012 through February of this year when they pulled the channel off the air. Now we're trying to raise $22,000 to continue reaching people with the message of liberty in places where it's needed most. Please visit our Indiegogo fundraiser at africa.lrn.fm. Give what you can and share the link with your friends. africa.lrn.fm.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.FM.
This is Free Talk Live. You can join us right here, toll-free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And with you tonight, you've got Ian.
And Mark.
Don't forget, you can join us online over at freetalklive.com. You can enjoy the features that we share with you on the site over at freetalklive.com. And some of those things include great discounts on awesome products like Cameron Hughes Wine. We're talking about the highest quality wines out there, just relabeled, essentially. Cameron Hughes goes out, he buys the excess from the fancy wineries, and then he puts his own label on them, with their permission, and sells them as Cameron Hughes wine. CHwine.com, you put in code FTL, you get some special deals, as well as free shipping, which, if you think about it, shipping anything is expensive these days, but shipping liquid is particularly expensive. It's, you know, tends to be a heavy product, and so you get free shipping with code FTL. Plus, you'll get 20% off an amazing Cabernet Sauvignon that we recently enjoyed here at the Free Talk Live studios. We had a actually it was at the Keene Activist Center, which is right next door. But we had a wine tasting with this wine and some of the others from Cameron Hughes.
It's excellent.
This was the best of the lot in the majority opinion. Yeah, everybody's got their preferences. But of the people who were at the wine tasting, they loved, many of them, the Cabernet in this case. It's lot 502, which is on hold waiting for you at 20% off the already amazing price. Because again, Cameron Hughes, when he relabels this wine from the fancy vineyards, his regular price is a fraction of what you'd normally pay if you actually bought it from the vineyard from which it comes. So go to chwine.com, get this amazing cab, lot 502, for 20% off. It's already shockingly low price. And it's only available, by the way, this deal, through Friday of this week. So do not delay. Get your hands on some wine from chwine.com. Try some other flavors, too. There's all kinds of different options over there at chwine.com. Code FTL. You click the microphone in the upper left-hand corner. Type in FTL. You'll get the discount and free shipping on top of that. chwine.com. As we continue with your calls and thoughts, the stories were coming out of the mainstream media yesterday that the Crips and the Bloods were targeting the police, that they had called a truce so they could fight the police more effectively. But according to the gang members themselves, that's not, in point of fact, what happened. They were interviewed on WBAL-TV about this, where they said their goal was to end the fighting between the gangs so they could protect their city from the rioters. And personally, I believe them. Mark, you aren't believing them simply because they've been involved in some gang-related activity at some point in the past. But I remind you that a lot of gang-related activity is stuff like selling drugs and, you know, prostitution and running card games. I mean, these are harmless activities that, you know, don't create a victim. And these gang members are just the entrepreneurs who are willing to bring these products and services to the streets.
Traditionally, gangs have seen value in providing protection services in their given neighborhoods. There's no doubt about that. But at the same time, you know, many of these gangs are recruiting young people. And it seems like to me, if there are going to be local rioters in Baltimore, that probably the first demographic and psychographic of people mm-hmm. that are going to riot are the sort of people who would have earlier perhaps joined a criminal gang, right?
Not necessarily. There's all kinds of reasons to commit a riot. I mean, if you look at the Keene riots here during Pumpkin Fest, how many criminal gangs were in the streets at that time? Are you going to count the frat boys as gangsters?
No, I don't think so.
Well, they were overturning cars, pulling signs out of the ground, getting into fights, throwing bottles. I mean, there was all kinds of dangerous stuff happening there.
Yeah, I mean, they fit the demographics of the people who would do that in that circumstance.
Yes, you can certainly say that young males are likely to be participating in riots, and yes, young males are likely to join into gangs. But that doesn't follow that necessarily all gang members support rioting. No, that all gang members.
I'm not
support...
claiming all gang members do, Ian. I'm just saying that I'm just intuiting this, right? Like, yes, I do believe Oath Keepers, which is an organization of largely grown men. Mm-hmm. Who have dedicated their lives mostly to protecting the country in whatever way they see it. Now, look, I don't see it the same way they do, but that's what their dedication lies. Yes, I do believe what they say a little more often than I believe, you know, what the Crips and the Bloods say. Sure, they got some bad press, and now they're coming out and saying something different. I'm interested in what they're saying.
How often does that happen?
But I'm not going to just believe everything they say simply because some criminal gang came out and said that that's, oh, no, that's not what's happening.
Why do you keep calling them a criminal gang?
That's precisely what they are.
No, not necessarily. Each individual, Mark, is responsible for their own actions. If these gang members have
individually... Which is joining a gang, sir!
If these gang members... Some of them join the gang simply because they want to have friends.
Don't they have violent acts as initiations for these gangs?
Some do. I don't know if all of them do. I don't know, Mark.
Don't these gangs go to war with other gangs over turf?
Yeah, they do. And they're calling a truce so they can protect the neighborhood, so they can protect the properties.
Note, Oath Keepers did not have to file a truce with
anyone.
There's
no doubt that I'm not defending a lot of what gangs are known for doing, Mark, but to just label people a certain way because of something, you know, a group that they've joined, I don't think is necessarily fair. Let's look at individuals and the individual's actions. Did each person in the gang commit a violent act? I don't know what the initiation is.
I don't either.
For the Crips
and I know
the
Bloods. That violent acts are occurring in Baltimore. Mm-hmm. I can see the demographics of those people that are committing the acts. I only suggested that the people that would join criminal gangs that have violent interactions with each other are likely to be the sort of people that are rioting now.
Fine. Okay. I see where you're coming from. Is it possible that they're telling the truth?
Is it possible that they are telling the truth?
That they've actually had a truce so they can protect their neighborhoods and so they can stop looting.
Weren't you just saying that these are individual actions? So I don't think they're controlling the actions of everybody in the gang.
Is it possible the people who are saying that we're out there trying to stop the rioting, trying to stop the looting, is it possible that they're telling the truth?
Yes.
Okay.
Sure it is.
Let's go to Stu listening in
Georgia. But I don't think
they
speak for everybody in the gang.
Obviously not. Stu, you're on Free Talk Live.
Good evening, Jeff. And by the way, it's wonderful having you back on the air in North Florida and South Georgia. We miss you for a couple of years, and we really love you libertarian guys.
Good, good. Yeah, it's actually our third radio station we've been on in Tallahassee, so it is good to be back, and thanks for tuning back in. Go ahead with your thoughts tonight.
Yeah, well, I just want to tell you, I am a refugee from the city of Miami. On May 17th, 1980, a verdict came down that gave police officers the right to walk away from beating a known drug dealer to death, a man named Arthur McDuffie, on May 17th, my city was in flames. By May 18th, a lot of white-owned businesses were burning. Silver Cadillacs were riding around. Nation of Islam were popping out of these silver Cadillacs, showing these kids how to make firebombs. And a police precinct was under siege near the Overtown District. There's a pattern here where mass media takes sides with against the police, and I'm seeing this again and again and again.
I have not seen mass media take sides against the police, and if you could do me a favor, maybe back off your phone by about an inch or an inch and a half. It might help out. There's a little bit of distortion. I want to hang on to you, though. I want to hear more about what you're saying, because I don't see that happening at all. I see the mass media, the mainstream media, just parroting what the police say without question in a lot of instances. But hang on, Stu. We'll bring you back. 855-450-FREE. That's the toll-free number here. 855-450-3733. There's more Free Talk Live coming up.
Hi, John Huebner from Midas Resources. Are you tired of watching your hard-earned assets dwindle away? As government spending is out of hand and the Federal Reserve is creating in excess of $20 billion a week, are you tired of stockbrokers gambling away your hard-earned money? Is this market a setup for a crash greater than 1987? Too many of today's policies resemble those that led to the collapse of 1929.
This is John Huebner, and that was me in 2007. And we all know what happened when the subprime credit bubble burst. By March 2009, the dollar lost 50% of its value. The entire U.S. banking system was on the verge of collapsing. Like all financial problems of the past, is history about to repeat itself? Call me, John Huebner, at 1-800-686-2237, extension 129, before it's too late to protect yourself. Will the oncoming catastrophe take all private IRAs, 401ks with it? There is a way to protect your hard-earned assets. Call me, John Huebner, at 1-800-686-2237. 6-2-2-3-7, extension 129.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the Free State, or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Excuse me, is this where I get a license to start a new business?
I wouldn't be hasty. You have to get a license to go out of business, too, you know.
Oh, well, look, I've invented this little anti-gravity machine, see?
Oh, is that why you're walking 2 inches above the floor?
Oh, yes, it's very comfortable. It saves on shoe leather.
Yeah, well, you have to fill out these forms and report to the Human Services Department of Manpower Orientation and register with the Fair Employment Practice Commission, and Hour Division of the Employment Standards Administration, the State Sales and Income Tax Division, the Internal Revenue Service,
look,
and the Social Security Administration of the Department of Health, Education, and Welfare. And, of course, OSHA.
OSHA? I thought that was a little town in Wisconsin.
You'll find out. Say, floating around like that could be dangerous. Have you checked with the Consumer Product Safety Commission?
Well, not yet.
Come to think of it, you actually are flying, aren't you? Look, you need to go over to the Federal Aviation Administration and the Transportation...
It's very hard to get anything done these days if you're in business. But free enterprise built this country. Think what could happen if we don't keep it free. a public service of this station and the Center for the Defense of Free Enterprise, Bellevue, Washington.
Besides, we just can't have people floating about unregulated, you know.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll-free here, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. How many times have you ever heard about the Crips and the Bloods calling a press conference together to set the record straight about what they're doing? I think that alone shows that something unusual is happening in Baltimore. They have called a truce for the purpose, they say, to actually protect their communities, to help keep people safe, to help stop looting. And Mark, you're just not believing them because they've done some crimes.
I don't know what
that
not believing them is. I don't know. I prefer you not characterize my position. Like, you always do that. You mm-hmm. try to simplify somebody's position and put them into create a straw man and then argue with that straw man.
Oh, so you're saying you do believe them?
I believe, you know, maybe the guy standing on the stage.
Oh, okay. Well, there's a whole group of them.
Well, there's a whole bunch of people calling themselves Crips and Bloods, and I'm willing to say that those guys do not speak for that organization.
Well, what if they do? Because there is a hierarchy, right?
Are you trying to suggest that no Crip and no Blood and no Black Gorilla family or whatever they're called has rioted at all in Baltimore?
I'm not suggesting that at all.
Excellent, because that would be a foolish position to take.
Are you suggesting there isn't a hierarchy in the Crips and the Bloods?
Sure there is.
That there are people who will take orders from the higher-ups?
Maybe they've changed some things.
You ever
things.
Heard of mafia soldiers before?
Sure.
All right.
Yep.
So 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number here tonight. Let's go back to Stu. He's in Southwest Georgia. Now, Stu, you were saying that back in Miami, you were involved, or not involved, but you were nearby in the area when there was some rioting that happened then, and that you believe that the mainstream media tends to take the side of the rioters against police. Is that right?
Well, let me just mention, Channel 10 WPLG.
And can you do me a favor? I'm sorry to bug you about this, but like back off the phone maybe about an inch or so.
Okay, I'll do that. Is that better?
It is a little better. Go ahead.
Yeah, our ABC affiliate at the time was WPLG Channel 10, and there was an ongoing investigative report by a man who we will simply call him Clarence, and he's a white guy, and he was really against the police, and he forgot to mention that the man that was beaten to death by the cops was a drug dealer. He had a tendency to be violent with the cops, and after they were acquitted, our city was in ruins for quite some time in certain neighborhoods. Mostly white businesses were targeted, and that's why I tend to aim at the media in a lot of these situations.
So you're basing your opinion about the media in 2015 on something that happened 30 years ago?
Because of the patterns. There are certain reoccurring patterns that I see, like with the L.A. riots way back in the early 90s. And, yeah, I know it seems a little misdirected, but I keep seeing these patterns reoccurring, and it just looks like the same thing to me over and over again.
I don't think it's the media on this one. I've got to say, I think that it looks a lot more like the media uses terms like riot to describe what black people do and disturbance to describe what white kids do when sporting events happen. And right. You often won't hear that terminology. So there's some loaded stuff that goes on, one side or the other. Look, I get that there's a lot of people with a lot of criminal records, Michael Brown, not such a hot guy, and that sort of thing. But I think what we're seeing is just a community that is sick and tired of feeling the way they feel about the police, about people that they're forced to pay for. They feel subjugated or whatever. And look, I don't think every black person is part of the black community. I don't think the black community is necessarily only comprised of black people. But I think that this black community is sick of something, and that they're beginning to communicate this at this point in the only way that they feel like anybody's going to listen to.
May I just ask, though, is it possible, I know this is a weird question, but are we seeing a lot of this in many ways because of the man in the White House? Is there any connection there, do you think, in his politics?
No, not at all. There have been riots going on for a long time, and I thank you, Stu, for the call tonight. Our toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE.
Obama said that he wanted to have a national conversation about race. I'm almost of the opinion that I am sick of conversations about race. It almost seems like this is just, you know, it just keeps on rehashing and reopening old wounds that never get a chance to heal. How much of this is perception and how much of it is reality? I think it's both, right? Like, I think that there is institutionalized racism and no doubt about it. But I also think that people can perceive things that aren't necessarily racism as racism and just kind of perpetuates things. There was some talk, I think it was Michelle Obama said something about Barack Obama being asked to get some drinks or something from the White House because he was wearing a suit. Maybe somebody didn't recognize him. I can't remember exactly what it is, but there's some stories of some wealthy black people essentially saying they were treated like servants. It was unacceptable. And what I told in the story is when I was younger, I used to go to Home Depot. I go to Home Depot still, but it doesn't happen to me as much as it used to. People would always ask me where things were, if I could show them how something worked or something. And I didn't own an orange shirt, people.
Yeah.
People would just ask me. And a lot of times they would say, oh, I thought you worked here. I just looked like a guy who worked at Home Depot, I guess.
Yeah, I still get that sometimes.
It doesn't make me
not
feel
at Home Depot, but
bad,
like Walmart.
Right? Like, I'm ready to help somebody.
Right.
This is a Home Depot, I assume, is a job that's not much better than minimum wage when you start.
Yeah,
so they
not.
Were calling me, a servant. And the fact is I am your servant. Hopefully I serve you every day. That's what I attempt to do in my life is to be a servant to people.
You should all give my best answer if I'm at Walmart or something like that and somebody asks me for something. Sometimes I know the answer and other times I have to say, I'm sorry, I don't know.
If it's the electronics department, they've struck it. They've struck gold, right? Like, you could really help them. And at Home Depot, I can help these people. Yeah. Usually we're talking about older ladies asking me these questions. I don't know why they can't figure out I'm not wearing an orange apron, but I don't assume anything about them other than, well, that's a little obtuse, but all right. I'm happy to help in any way I can because I'd want you to help my mother if she was there. That's all.
So the gang members, back to the freethoughtproject.com, announced they were forming a new faction which will be concerned with protecting the community and stopping the senseless violence that is carried out by both private and public individuals. And then in another video published by the Baltimore Sun, rival gang members were shown meeting in churches, speaking of peace and justice. One gang member told reporters that, quote, they don't want to see us call a truce because they want us out there killing each other. So I'm going to give you the actual audio here from WBAL-TV and their report on this.
Tell me what's going on.
Man, we want to tell the people of the city right now, of Baltimore City, that the image that they're trying to portray of the gangs in Baltimore, the BGF, the Bloods, the Crips, we did not make that truce to harm cops. We did not come together against the cops. We're not about to allow y'all to paint this picture of us. We got soldiers out here right now. We dirty. We dirty. They threw bombs at us for trying to stop what's going on right now. Y'all not about to do that to us.
So your game plan tonight has been to stop the violence.
To stop what's going on. That's all we trying to do. We want justice for Freddie Gray. We believe in that.
What do you think when you see this happening in the streets? Businesses looted, cars on fire, police injured.
It just makes us look bad. It makes us look real bad. It's backing up what they're saying about us. They saying we animals and we acting like savages out here. But I also agree with I don't agree with what's going on, but I understand what's going on. You know what I'm saying? I understand why people are mad, but we got to handle things another way.
What do you think?
Me, I basically think the same thing. I mean, we've been out here all day trying to prevent people from breaking the stores. They hit us with a bomb. They burnt my shirt. They ripped it, and we were still standing right there as a whole. They heard it, but we came right back there, hold hands together, and we marched together. Down here, we still holding strong.
So I think in the same way that you could actually, and we've talked about this before, that the mafia, you could actually, in some cases, count on them to provide the protection that you're paying for, right?
I think the opening scene in The Godfather is something about some guy coming in and asking for a favor from the Godfather, and he says, someday I may need a favor from you, right? I mean, this is... And John Gotti was known for throwing block parties and sort of helping in his neighborhood, wherever that was.
In Mexico, it's sort of well known in a lot of places that the drug gangs are actually providing protection for people there. No, obviously they're murdering people
seems,
as well.
Seems
but,
tenuous.
But you know, it depends, right? It depends on if they're in a rival gang, you're likely to get murdered. But if you're just the average people, the women and the children in the area, you usually can count on these guys to protect you.
Operative being usually.
855-450-FREE. Well, you know, sometimes can't count on the police. In fact, frequently can't. It's Free Talk Live.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict. Legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
You've been lied to. Being overweight is not about overeating, not exercising, or a lack of self-control. Diets, gyms, and pills can't fix it. It's your hormones. Go to 99skinny.com for a free video where Dr. Steven Siskin explains the four hormonal barriers to weight loss in men and women over 40.
When I first started losing the weight, all my clothes were falling off. I got some skinny jeans, and my husband is chasing me around the table again. I couldn't be happier.
Go to 99skinny.com to see this riveting free video. That's 99skinny.com.
Making the right decisions is a challenge to investors. Are we going to see economic growth, slide into a recession, or at worst, depression? Hi, Ted Anderson from Midas Resources. We all know when a company acts irresponsibly, divesting ourselves in a move towards safety is prudent. When the market becomes volatile, U.S. treasuries are a safe haven. But what do you do when the U.S. government overextends itself and spends beyond its means? Many investors are turning toward gold as a common sense alternative to traditional paper investments. Midas Resources has put together a powerful book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, discussing costs, benefits, risks, featuring full color illustrations, weights, and measures. The book is free and can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. Paper investments are dwarfed by gold's 6,000-year history. Discover how gold may be right for you and your IRA by calling 800-686-2237. Whether buying or it's time for you to sell, the book is free. Call 800-686-2237.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Are you tired of governments around the world killing innocent people? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin is money that cannot be inflated or controlled by any state. By continuing to use their money, you're perpetuating the killing. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available to you now. Learn it, use it, spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. It's weusecoins.com.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You can join us here in these remaining moments by dialing toll-free 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. The worst in Baltimore is bringing out some unusual allies in the form of the Crips and the Bloods, who some of them are teaming up to protect their neighborhoods, to provide the protection that, by the way, the police aren't giving, because the police can't. You know, even if they wanted to, there aren't enough cops out there to go and stand guard at businesses and protect them from being looted. And of course, the police focus on other things. And, you know, rightly or wrongly, there's valid critique on, I'm sure, things that can be said about whatever the police are doing. And I'm sure in some cases they are trying their best to protect people and things. I'll give some of them the benefit of the doubt. And I'm also going to give these Crips and Bloods the benefit of the doubt and believe that what they're saying is true, that they're out there standing guard, where they were talking about how they got into a fight with some of the people who were trying to loot a store, that they stood guard and got their, you know, got torn up because they had a bomb thrown at them and were attacked by people who were trying to loot a store. So we're sharing that story, and you can, of course, share your thoughts on whatever's on your mind here. You can also join us online at freetalklive.com. And if you want to support the show, then please amp Free Talk Live. Just go to amp.freetalklive.com. It's $5 a month. You can use any major credit card through PayPal, or you can use Visa or MasterCard right there on our website at amp.freetalklive.com. You get perks like access to the amp-only call-in lines, amp-only podcast, which doesn't have the regular commercials that our standard podcast does, and you also get access to the amp-only Facebook group, which is one of the newer things and also one of the coolest things. It's turned into a nice community of Free Talk Live listeners.
Yeah.
It's exclusive because you got to pay for the AMP program to get into it. But it's, again, only $5 a month. And if you really like what we're doing, that $5 is invested into Free Talk Live. That $5 is added together with other people's $5. And then, you know, we do things with it to help propagate the ideas of liberty by getting the show on more radio stations. We just announced a couple of new stations tonight in Owensboro, Kentucky. So welcome aboard to all of our new listeners. And we can have 300 stations. We've got over 160 right now. We can have 300. It's just a matter of
it's
funding.
Money. It's really about money. We can have more stations with more money. There's no doubt about it.
So please go to amp.freetalklive.com as we go to James in Kalamazoo, Michigan. James, you're on Free Talk Live.
Good evening. I just wanted to mention a lot of people, you know, and I wouldn't say the majority of people, but there are plenty of people out there that just look for reasons to riot and protest. And I just want to bring this up. Last night, after it was shortly after the show was done, I was going by the downtown park here in Kalamazoo and heard someone yelling on a bullhorn. So I had to go investigate, see what was going on. And I ended up video recording the whole thing, followed them around, and they weren't even yelling about what was his name, Freddie Gray. No, they were bringing up Michael Brown and Eric Gardner. They didn't even know what they were protesting.
Well, what do you mean they didn't know what they were protesting? It sounded like they were protesting Eric Gardner.
What they told me was it had to do with the Baltimore thing, mm-hmm. You know, with Freddie Gray, but they didn't even know his name. Mm. So it's just one of those things, you know. If I just think that protesting in the streets, it's a fundamental right of ours. It's, freedom of speech, but I just think that organizers out there need to actually have a message. And what are people doing out marching the streets at, 10:30, 11 o'clock at night?
Well, I guess people, I mean, the ready, fire, aim thing is pretty common among humans. I mean, this is a person who feels passionate, right? And they're, they're uninformed. The vast majority of Americans are. We found out that people don't even know who Edward Snowden is.
Mm-hmm.
I love these questions. They get Jimmy Kimmel to go out there and ask questions. The most recent one that I saw was, do you think that the United States government should change its schedule for earthquakes? And asked people about it. Right. I mean, this is just how dumb people are.
Do they actually send Jimmy Kimmel onto the streets, or is it a producer?
It's just some producer person asking, getting people's, asking people whether they saw the United States government's announcement about changing the earthquake schedule. And people are saying, yes, I was at home when it happened. they're developing whole stories. Yeah. I mean, there's a lot of people out there that, A, feel passionately, and B, don't know everything they should know. But to expect a talk show host level depth of knowledge from the average individual is somewhat unfair. At the very least, they're doing something, even if they don't know much what or why.
I host a talk show and I don't know jack. I can tell you that.
That is why I'm here, is in order to you know, Ian brings us in and takes us out, does it very well, and then I make his show look informed.
There you go, Mark. It's all about you.
Mm-hmm.
James?
Well, it is.
Thanks for the call. All right. Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. So WBAL-TV reporting with a gang member, with gang members who are teaming up to protect their community rather than fight amongst themselves. Here's more from the interview at WBAL.
We back there hold hands together, and we march together down here. We still holding strong, and we just want them to stop hurting us so we can just live our life and keep going. We trying to help them like we helping us. Without them doing that, it's just going to make everybody angry. We don't want to be angry. So we, as a whole community, we make everybody, you know, calm everybody down, because they can't calm to us because they done already hurt a lot of people, killed a lot of people for no apparent reason.
Now, I think he's interchangeably using the term they to mean the police in some parts of what he's saying, and they meaning, you know, like the looters. So at one point, he was discussing how they had attacked them while they were defending a store from being looted. I suspect he didn't mean the police were looting the store in that case. But when he's talking about being attacked and killed, he is referring to the police.
Yeah, you're just kind of having to figure out what he is talking about here with all the pronouns. But yeah, I get where he's coming from. I think these guys really were standing in front of this store trying to protect this store. And I think that it's an admirable act. But you know, I mean, it's
good.
It's
I'm
hard
to take them at their word. Here
hard to look be part of a criminal gang and look like
the Bloods right here. This Bloods, we got the Pyrus over here, and we got Bloods over here. We stand as one though. We're one right now.
It's Black Man United.
I'll go
Saturday. The pictures that went viral Saturday.
We're not Blood or BGF. We are Black men, and we are united, and we're not going to stop. No matter if y'all even keep on trying to say we out here trying to shoot police, we're not trying to shoot police. We're not going to let that stop us from doing what we already originally planned to do.
So people who are watching right now, what do you want to say to them? How do you want to explain what is happening tonight?
Basically, stop believing everything you hear in the media. If you were not at that protest on the day that we protested for Freddie, you don't know what actually happened. They didn't tell y'all that when we walked past the eateries downtown that people threw beers at us. People called us names. You know, everything. To be blunt, they called us those things. So the protest was agitated, you know?
So you guys feel that you're getting the blame, correct?
Yes, exactly.
For what's happening.
Man.
And
a lot
you're
of the blame.
Saying that
yes, man.
That as member of the Bloods,
just because we black and we have flags on, they assume that we gonna hurt somebody or do this or go and bring the next person down. And most of us, as us older people, we bring everybody closer, make sure they got jobs, go to school on time and all that, but
see, this is why I think you're not being fair, Mark. I mean, these guys are, like you said, the older people in the gangs. These are you know, guys in their mid to late 20s here, perhaps even their early 30s. That these are people who have more perspective. They may have seen how some of the things they did when they were younger were the wrong things to do. And I think it's not fair of you to label them as criminal gangs. Individuals can do things that are criminal. And also, what is defined as criminal is not necessarily something that's wrong, right? So it's a criminal act to have marijuana on your body, but you and I don't necessarily think of that as a crime because there's not actually a victim. So many of these gang members may never have actually created a victim in some of the supposed crimes that they've committed, but either way, whether they've committed a crime or not, it's not fair to collectivize them as criminal.
I'm going to have a very difficult time deciding that a member of a gang is a mature individual, okay? They're not acting like it. If they were...
This sounds pretty mature to me. What they're saying here,
they wouldn't have to call a truce. I don't have shooting wars going on with other people.
Yeah.
You know why? Because I'm not some immature a-hole that's arguing over turf so that my minions can go out and sell drugs. I would have left the gang. That's what a mature person does. There's no arguing for this. Are these guys maturing? It certainly sounds like they're taking some huge strides towards becoming active and
so
productive
members
of their...
Then.
I absolutely need to show them exactly what it is that they're doing that's right and what it's doing that's wrong. I'm not going to candy coat
like,
it pander.
He's black, he got a flag on, he's doing the wrong thing, and we not doing the wrong thing. Like me, I just came home, and I'm trying to do any and everything to prevent the going back home. You know what I'm saying? I got locked up for helping a female out downtown on Baltimore Street. Her beef, I was beating up, and I stopped it. I tried to prevent it. I used self-defense, even though there's no self-defense law in there, but I still locked out. They locked me up just because I'm me.
I'll put the rest of it on our Facebook and Twitter. You can check it out. There's another 2 minutes to the video, the interview with these guys. Sounds to me like they're doing the right thing, and they should be encouraged and, I think, taken at their word. We'll see you tomorrow night online in the meantime at freetalklive.com.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Rebel Love Show is next, live after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, April 28th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.58 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,206 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $226. Antiwar.com reports during the brief summer Israeli war against the Gaza Strip, Israeli forces repeatedly attacked UN facilities, particularly schools that they knew for a fact were full of displaced civilians. The UN inquiry expressed dismay at the Israeli strikes, noting they killed 44 Palestinian civilians and wounded 227 others in attacks on emergency shelters. Israel has defended the attacks, insisting that other closed schools were being used to hide weapons. Oddly, those sites don't appear to have been attacked, and Israel instead hit UN sites that they knew were loaded down with civilians that had just days prior been ordered out of their homes by the Israeli military. Pentagon lawyers issued their own report, and while they insisted they weren't judging specific incidents, they did praise the Israeli military, insisting that the decisions on targets to strike were largely in line with what the U.S. military would have done under the same circumstances. The killings loom large in a potential ICC investigation into Israeli war crimes against civilians in the occupied territories and reflect the continued efforts by the U.S. to keep Israel immune from any consequences for their actions. In Survivor Max by Davi Barker, 11-year-old Max must survive the zombie apocalypse alone in New Hampshire. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the lame brains swarm his home searching for living flesh. Max must apply his porcupine Freedom Scouts training to plan his escape, but first, he must prove that he's too smart to die. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook and Amazon, or read Chapter 1 free at SurvivorMax.com. UPI reports Maryland Governor Larry Hogan declared a state of emergency Monday and deployed the National Guard in response to violent clashes between police and rioters. Demonstrators in Baltimore turned violent after the funeral of Freddie Gray, who died after suffering a broken spine while in police custody. Protesters appeared to hurl items at police, and authorities used pepper spray to try to disperse the crowd. Hogan said the looting and acts of violence in Baltimore will not be tolerated. He added in a statement, "I strongly condemn the actions of the offenders who are engaged in direct attacks against innocent civilians, businesses, and law enforcement officers. There is a significant difference between protesting and violence, and those committing these acts will be prosecuted under the fullest extent of the law." At a news conference held by Baltimore officials Monday evening, Police Colonel Daryl D'Souza said 15 officers were injured, two of them remain hospitalized. CNN reports one of its photographers was also injured and transported to a hospital. There is no report on the number of protesters injured by police. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. Reuters reports a day before the U.S. Supreme Court hears landmark arguments on whether the Constitution provides a right to same-sex marriage. Activists on both sides of the contentious social issue converged on the white marble courthouse to voice their views. Anti-gay rights activists rallied in front of the courthouse steps condemning same-sex marriage, while a line snaked around the block of people, many displaying gay rights messages, hoping to snag one of the limited number of seats available in the courtroom for Tuesday's 2.5-hour oral arguments. The nine justices will be hearing arguments concerning same-sex marriage restrictions imposed in Kentucky, Michigan, Ohio, and Tennessee, four of the 13 states that still outlaw such marriages. The ruling, due by the end of June, will determine whether same-sex marriage will be legal nationwide. At a small Monday morning rally, opponents of same-sex marriage railed against judges who have struck down state same-sex marriage bans. Tuesday's arguments will be divided into two parts. The first, set for 90 minutes, is on whether the Constitution's guarantee of due process and equal protection under the law means states must allow same-sex couples to marry. The second part, scheduled for an hour, concerns whether states must recognize same-sex marriages that take place out of state. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Do you sometimes feel that healthy eating can be a lot of work with very little reward? Well, no need to worry any longer. Here are the Onion's tips for healthy eating. First, identify your weaknesses, and then condition yourself to avoid problem foods by associating them with deceased relatives, unrequited loves, and traumatic events. Remember, alcohol is a source of empty calories, so be sure to keep your drinking under control. Unless you're really f***ing stressed out, like if something s*** happens at work, or if your cat gets hit by a car. If you find yourself suddenly craving a fatty food, let yourself enjoy the best of both worlds. Tape a slice of ham to your tongue and slowly absorb the taste throughout the day without swallowing. Stay motivated by paying yourself $1 every day until you meet your weight loss goals. At the end of 10 years' time, spend that cash on a cosmetic operation of your choice. There, now you're ready to begin your new healthy lifestyle.
This is the Onion News Network.